You guys got it. Just let me know when I need to start talking. All right. I'll do my opening scene setter break, and then it'll be us three. My math, I got 30 seconds. I don't know if this is right or not, but.
Was a graduate from Gardner Newton Middle School, a rising freshman at LaGrange High School. Bell Kravis was a proud member of the ninth grade and JV football team. He brought a great deal of leadership and passion to the program in a short amount of time. Tonight, Grange High School football coaches, players, faculty, staff, administration, like to present the Tucker family with.
I'm not hearing program.
It's time for the Grange Granger football, right here on 100.9 WCJM The Bull. Granger football is brought to you by Holmes Pharmacy, Mallory Insurance, Remax Results Agents Rob and Joel Upchurch, Willstar West Georgia Medical, and Emory Southern Orthopedics. LaGrange Granger football can be heard anywhere by downloading our iHeartRadio app. Watch online at eagle1023.com. Now to the stadium and the voice of the Grangers, Michael Buchanan.
Well, the 2017 season arrives with the Grangers looking to turn around the 2-8 season they had last year. Remember, they were just a few plays here and there from being 5-5. But this year, the road is steep. The Maxwell computer projections have LaGrange with the second toughest schedule in all of Quad A. But the way you get better is by playing better competition, and it starts tonight. Hello from Callaway Stadium. This is LaGrange High Granger football. Along with Coach Cal Hires and Tommy Whitworth, I'm Michael Buchanan. Our producer is Tucker Browning, and our board operator is Taylor Sears and Mason Black. Talking with the coaches, they all seem to have one common thread about these players. They are playing as a team. Irk Russell once had the mantra of big team over little me, and these players seem to embrace that. And that kind of attitude will lead to success both on and off the field, and they'll look for that tonight. The first test is against the sixth-ranked Callaway Cavaliers. Coming up next, we'll have the pregame comments from Tommy and Cal setting the stage for tonight's game. Then we'll have the pregame conversation with head coach Diallo Burks. And then finally, in the pregame show, we will have the game and field conditions, followed by the coin toss and the opening kickoff. But first, we're going to step aside for this two-minute break. This is LaGrange High Granger football on the Eagle Sports Network.
Here's Perry Prather, head pharmacist at Holmes Pharmacy.
The joy of coming in to work in the pharmacy every day is to interact with the patients, get a feel for them, understand them, love them, first of all. You got to love your patients. You got to love people. That's what we do. And as a person and as a business, that's my thing, is I want to give them the exceptional care. Everybody that comes in here that we care about, and they feel like this is home for them when they get the medicine.
HolmesPharmacy.com in LaGrange and Hamilton.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at RE/MAX Results, because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
There's a secret to beating injuries or ailments. Get the right team. Emory Southern Orthopedics, well-trained, experienced doctors, nurses, and staff are that team. These teammates listen and understand your specific condition and provide high-quality hometown care that will get you back into your game. For more information about Emory Southern Orthopedics team, visit www.southernorthopedics.com.
Tara, are you okay?
Yes, I can't believe you found me. I have car trouble and there you are.
Yeah, that's State Farm's 24/7 access.
It's like we have this mental telepathy, you know?
Well, you did start filing your claim with your mobile device. You can access State Farm on your phone, online, even in person at one of the 18,000 neighborhood
State Farm offices. See? Mental telepathy.
State Farm is there for you anytime, anywhere. Get to a better state. State Farm.
Connect telepathically with Agent Matt Orr on the square in downtown LaGrange.
Now back to LaGrange Granger football on 100.9 WCJN The Bull.
Welcome back to Callaway Stadium as the Grangers getting set to take on the Callaway Cavaliers. Alongside me here in the booth is Coach Cal Hires, and on the sideline is Tommy Whitworth. And guys, let's first talk about what just happened on the field. They had a ceremony honoring the young man who had passed away from drowning over at the Callaway pool, Narquavius Tucker. And it's sad when anybody, you know, passes away from something like that, but 14 years old, incoming freshman, that's got to tear your heart out.
Yeah, it does, and it's nothing that anybody wants to face, and when it does happen, it is just the most tragic thing. You know, it's going to be I guess it's going to be really hard to play tonight with that on your mind, but it will serve as an inspiration, because now you play for, you know, more than just every day.
More than just the win, yeah. And Tommy, both LaGrange and Callaway teams were out there for that. Good community showing there.
Absolutely. I think the whole... Can you hear me up there?
Yeah, we got you now.
Okay, it's just a show of class from both sides, really was. And a lot of emotions tonight. It's opening game, first thing, but having that hanging over you is makes us realize what really is important in this game of life that we have. And, of course, this is just a game of football, but... we're all a team, we're all a family, and when one person hurts, everybody hurts.
The one thing I saw over the Heard County game last year was the, last 2 weeks ago was that they also had a moment of silence, and they also had cans to have for folks to donate there at the concession stand and the front gate for folks to donate. That that Heard County folks are a lot of class folks there too, Tommy.
That's right. I'm down here talking to Coach Kenny Moore down here, and we're just talking about how cool it is on the sideline. And all the wind is blowing so hard, it blew my hat off. I don't know.
It is quite hot. I appreciate Kenny Moore. Kenny Moore, real quick story about Kenny Moore. I don't know if he remembers this or not. 2003, 2004, something like that. There was a game where
a team took a
penalty on purpose to get a better angle, I guess, on a field goal. So I asked Coach Moore in an email. I says, "Okay, since he's the math wizard, I asked him where on the field is the optimal place to kick a field goal, because as you get move farther back, the angle is narrower. The angle is narrower as you move farther back, but you're more square with it." And he said that to his calculus class, and I think Coach Moore is listening in right now. I remember you putting that to your calculus class. Is that right?
We did. We looked at that.
I can't remember the answer. I think the optimal place was about the 50-yard line.
No, it was for the opponents maybe, but for us, it was actually 2 yards inside the end zone was the answer to that.
Okay, I remember working on that. That was a fun problem.
It was, and I do appreciate your help on that. Kenny Moore, he's former assistant coach here at LaGrange High, retired now, and he's just a lot of fun to be around. Good guy.
A really first-class man.
Let's take a look now at tonight's game. The Grangers had struggled against Heard County in the first half with the starters, mainly because that high-powered quarterback they've got there that's going to be going to Ohio State next year. But LaGrange's offense wasn't too bad. They were 3-and-out the first series, but then grinded out a good long drive before missing the field goal. Defensively, they looked pretty decent too. Again, they gave up a couple big plays with that quarterback, but they caused a fumble at the 1 yard line and recovered it there. And I play defense. I would love a 2-0 score with great defensive plays, and I cheered loud. We weren't on the air, so I couldn't. Yeah. But I was loud when I saw that ball get popped loose there near the end zone, and the Grangers recovered.
And you know, that's something that can, you know, bring some momentum into the next game, knowing that you can stiffen up and cause a turnover. And, you know, when you play with confidence, good things start happening, and you know it's just a whole different level of play whenever you've got the confidence factor going on.
The Grangers finished warming up, and now they're getting their final instruction. Tommy, the what did you notice with the players warming up?
Well, they're just stretching, and looked like they had their game hats on, and were concentrating on their whatever position coach had them doing at that time. I think they're a little more focused this year in a way. It seems like there's a mission in their eyes, sort of. It's a good feel.
Standing right in front of you is something new that I didn't notice in years past. They've got a Emory Healthcare tent there for the folks. Tell us about what those are all about.
Well, I'm fixing to go put my head in there and see what it looks like in there, but they may slap it. But Wes is in there manning that tent. Wes Abel's in there manning it, so it's
he's keeping cool is what he's doing.
Wes, has this thing got air conditioning in it? He said the air conditioning is not working. But they do have a nice table here with all the supplies and stuff they'll need when they have somebody injured. They have to retape them or work on them or have the doctor. I saw Dr. Brian Terry out. Spoke with him just a second ago. He's going to be our sideline doctor tonight. Hopefully he will just be walking in and watching, but he'll be ready if they need him.
It ought to be at a pretty cool place in there with Wesley being the cool dude that he is.
Yeah, Wesley is the coolest dude in the play. He got the shade over his head. And there's no breeze in here, is it, Wes?
No.
No.
He's shaking his head. He's drawing a little sweat over here. He probably would let me borrow that hat of his if he was a good man, but I think he's going to keep that hat on his head.
You'd have to fight him for that hat.
We talk about this a lot and this time of year, and obviously hydration is definitely going to be key, making sure that the kids hopefully have started hydrating way before today. It's hot out there. It is. I have to look at my thermometer here real quick. But it's hot today. It's going to be hot tomorrow when I'm in Peachtree City refereeing some soccer games. It says it's 89 degrees, but with a heat index of 98 with the humidity. Keeping cool, keeping from cramping. I understand there was a good bit of cramping last night with the troop game. That's going to be key.
Yeah, you know, this is the time of the year that athletes need to keep in mind that proper nutrition and hydration is key in order to have a successful first part of the season, because all the conditioning you do isn't going to be worth anything if you don't keep yourself prepared to play.
Yeah.
And, you know, you're not going to stop all the crampage, but you can alleviate it by having the proper amount of nutrients in your bloodstream by the time you get started.
All right, when we come back, I had a chance to talk with head coach Diallo Burks, and we'll have that conversation coming up after this two-minute break. This is LaGrange High Granger Football on the Eagles Sports Network.
LaGrange Banking is growing. We've opened a new location in Columbus, and we've adopted a new name that reflects our community roots with an eye on the future. Welcome to Calumet Bank, offering personal and business banking services with the friendliness of neighbors. We work on your schedule, offering daytime business hours and a complete set of mobile apps. Day or night, we've got you covered. Calumet Bank, same great services from people you already know. Life is better at Calumet. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's the step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at RE/MAX Results, because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
When it comes to your health, nobody beats the home team at WellStar West Georgia Medical Center. Named number one large hospital by Georgia Trend Magazine. Nationally ranked the top 100 hospital by Truven Health. And one of the 100 great community hospitals by Becker's Hospital Review. WellStar West Georgia Medical Center is your award-winning team in LaGrange. Visit wellstar.org/WGMC to learn more. We believe in life well lived.
Here's Perry Prather, head pharmacist at Holmes Pharmacy.
The joy of coming into work in the pharmacy every day is to interact with the patients, get a feel for them, understand them. Love, first of all, you got to love your patients, you got to love people. That's what we do. And as a person and as a business, that's my thing, is I want to give them the exceptional care. Everybody that comes in here that we care about, and they feel like this is home.
HolmesPharmacy.com and Brandon Hamilton.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Interview with Coach Burks coming in 3, 2, 1.
Time out for a pre-game conversation with head coach Diallo Burks. 2 weeks since the scrimmage.
Wow, some new coaches this year. Talk about the new coaches that are coming in.
We have Frank Caputo, our offensive coordinator, who's been around for a couple of years. He's very knowledgeable. Other wing to the offense, offensive line guy, who came from the building. He was retired. He was retired when he brought him out of retirement, becoming a coach. But he's been very instrumental in our offense and just establishing a relationship with our guys. We make a little run through a ball for you. Adam Dagler also came along with him from building. Our offensive line coach, weight room guy. He's high energy, how strong, you know, but like I said, he is a relationship guy as well. You know, he definitely loves the kids, but he's a competitor. He's a competitor. I like Adam because he's different. You know, you look at all the coaches we got, all of them are different, but, you know, he brings something to the table that's kind of unexplainable. You know, he's hungry. You can see it. He's hungry as a young coach. And, you know, his day of leading the program will be in the near future. Next, we have Coach RJ Miles. RJ was one of the guys that I coached at the Grange College before I left to go to True Pine and start my high school career. He's coaching our receivers. Marcus Blandberg was another one that coached beside me at the Grange College, former Granger as well. He's back. Coaching our defense backs, our secondary co-defense coordinator. So he also heads up our special team. So, you know, his energy and passing that he gives on the field, nobody's going to slack.
All right. Finally, keys to the game. Well, I know your assistant said every week last week, just make no mistakes and whatnot. Anything special that you can special tonight?
Well, we want to go out and just have fun, first of all. You know, we want to have fun. This is the first one. We don't want to look back and say, you know, what was. We don't want to look ahead and say what is. You know, we have to come out here and make mistakes. I don't know if I say that every week, but mistakes will kill all clubs. You know, and just play within in the scheme of what we've set. Play as a team.
Good luck, Nico.
Thank you.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's the step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at RE/MAX Results because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
When it comes to your health, Nova beats the home team at Wellstar West Georgia Medical Center. Named number one large hospital by Georgia Trend Magazine. Nationally ranked the top 100 hospital by Truven Health. And one of the 100 great community hospitals by Becker's Hospital Review. Wellstar West Georgia Medical Center is your award-winning team in LaGrange. Visit wellstar.org/WGMC to learn more. We believe in life well lived. LaGrange Banking is growing. We've opened a new location in Columbus, and we've adopted a new name that reflects our community roots with an eye on the future. Welcome to Calumet Bank, offering personal and business banking services with the friendliness of neighbors. We work on your schedule, offering daytime business hours and a complete set of mobile apps. Day or night, we've got you covered. Calumet Bank, same great services from people you already know. Life is better. At Calumet, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Tara, are you okay?
Yes, I can't believe you found me. I have car trouble and there you are.
Yeah, that's State Farm's 24/7 access.
It's like we have this mental telepathy, you know?
Well, you did start filing your claim with your mobile device. You can access State Farm on your phone, online, even in person at one of the 18,000 neighborhood
State Farm offices. See? Mental telepathy.
State Farm is there for you anytime, anywhere. Get to a better state. State Farm.
Connect telepathically with agent Matt Orr on the square in downtown LaGrange.
Now back to LaGrange Winter Football on 100.9 WCJM The Bull.
And welcome back to Callaway Stadium as the Grangers getting set to take on the Callaway Cavaliers. And looks like the head referee is getting ready to go out for the coin toss. The players, the captains have not come out. In fact, here we see the Callaway captains are starting to walk over here. The Grangers captains Here they are coming as well. Until they come out there, let me go ahead and tell you, the Callaway Cavaliers are in their white jerseys with a silver number. So that's going to be very interesting to be able to see those numbers as the night progresses. Red pants with the white stripes and the white helmets. Grangers are in the Granger blues, and boy, these look nice. New uniforms. Granger blue with the white sleeves and navy numbers on the sleeves, white numbers on the chest and on the backs, white pants, and of course the silver helmet. Well, those are white helmets. Excuse me, those aren't silver helmets. Those are white helmets with the Granger star on it. That's definitely a difference, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a white helmet with that silver flake in it.
Ah, okay.
With the traditional Granger stripes going over the top and the that Granger star on the side.
The captains are number 3, Desmond Williams, number 4, Cornell Kendrick, number 10, Jacoby Smith, and number 14, Charles Crawford. And with the coin toss, here's Tommy.
Guys, go ahead and introduce yourself and shake hands. All right, guys, my name is Derek Binion. That's Billy Osborne. He'll be the umpire. Make sure your players are properly equipped, and make sure we display proper sportsmanship throughout the game. All right, guys, I got a heads here, a tails there, a tails there, a heads here. What are you going to call before I flip it? What are you going to call?
Tail.
He's going to call tails before I flip it. It is a tails.
All right, so LaGrange lost the toss. Callaway elected to defer. So, of course, LaGrange then had the choice to receive or to kick off. Thankfully, they chose to receive, or else they'd be kicking off both halves. And Callaway is going to move from left to right. As you're looking at the radio dial, LaGrange will receive to start the game, moving right to left.
You know, back whenever I played high school ball, Michael, our coach always elected to kick off because he had so much confidence in our defense that we could get a four and out and end up in better field position than if we took the kickoff.
Interesting.
We made 3 straight runs to the semifinals on the two runs to the semifinals and 1 run to the first round of the playoffs doing that.
The 1 year that I played high school ball, we could have received every time and it wouldn't have mattered. We were 0-10 and we weren't that good. I mean, it was miserable.
But you had a good time, right?
We did. We did. Yeah. We did.
I've been on those teams.
I got to see several homecoming games. One of them was ours, but we had 4 homecoming games that we played.
Throughout my career, we suffered only 2 losses on the road.
Wow.
Yeah.
Good deal.
We spoiled quite a few homecoming games. Yeah. This sure is exciting, isn't it, Michael? I mean, Friday night, late August, 2 football teams fitting to square off. I can't think of anything better.
It's football season.
Gets your adrenaline pumping.
It sure does.
I tell you what, my apologies. Is it Adam? Adam Daigler, I believe, is the coach with the. He had the hair flowing last 2 weeks ago at Heard County. He looks like he's got it in a bun now. He was full of energy during the warm-ups. It made me want to run through a wall.
Hey, Tommy, go over there and headbutt one of them. Get them all fired up.
We're going to run this one back.
Back deep is number 30, Dylan Norville, a sophomore, in the middle there.
Jacoby is on the right.
Miles Johnson on the far side. And here's the kick. It's a deep one, and it's going to go into the end zone for a touchback. It looked like the sophomore Dylan was going to try to field it at the one, I think, but thankfully it went on through. And
yeah, he tried to field it before it went into the end zone.
I don't know if that would have been wise to do or not, but I don't know his running ability. We'll see it today.
Yeah, on those type kickoffs where there's a lot of hang time, you want to get back and have forward momentum when by the time you catch it, but he didn't have time to do that.
One receiver split out left. That is Quantavius Swanson, a junior. Charles Crawford is the quarterback. He's going to hand the ball off straight up the middle. Number four, Cornell Kendrick. We heard his name a lot last year. Going to hear it again this year. And he'll get about a two, maybe a three-yard gain.
Yeah, I think the Grangers are going to come out and try to establish the ground game with Cornell and the stall of running backs that they do have.
I was under the impression that LaGrange should have run the ball maybe a little bit more than they did last year with the depth of running backs they have. And now with the wing T, Coach Burks is saying, yeah, let's establish the run. Let's have a running game here. There's the run to Miles across the 25, 26, 27. Still pushing those legs. 28-yard line for Miles Johnson.
Just short of the yards needed.
Toss sweep to the right side, and it got outstanding blocking out there with the wing back and the fullback. Good yardage on that play.
You're correct,
and
Tommy. The after they unpiled the bodies, yeah, they showed to the 29-yard line.
It's about a foot short.
One receiver to the left side. That's number 13, Colby Patton.
He got.
And a little run up the middle. Got the first down and about a yard more. First and 10, Grangers.
A good play selection. Just everything on the ground so far.
Be glad when that sun goes down. I know Tommy would too. We got a glare here, so I'm having a little difficult time seeing.
I'm having a very difficult time trying to see numbers.
Well, I've finally got into some shade over here, and it's much easier.
First and 10, Grangers from the 31. And I can't hardly see the clock. We'll get the clock here in just a minute. Running off to the left side is number 7, Trez Delaney, a senior. But not much going. He got run out of bounds at the line of scrimmage.
Callaway did a good job of spreading that sweep, running that sweep into the sideline. Excellent inside-out pursuit.
Actually lost about a yard on it.
Second down. No score here. Opening drive of the game. Grangers with the ball. 10, looks like 13 left to go in the first quarter. Man in motion, fakes it, throws it, and caught. But Cornell Kendrick had a jump for it, lost his footing coming down, and is down at the 31-yard line, bringing up third and 10.
Cornell with a little flat pattern. If he would have been able to catch the ball while running, he could have got a few more yards out of that, but he had to turn into a wide receiver and jump up and catch that thing.
They'll come back to that play a little later on, I believe.
Oh, yeah. Good game for the Grangers to get their feet wet on. And now they're going to spread it out, go out of the wing tee, go into a bit of a spread as number 11, Jordan Ogletree, splits out far to the left. Number 6,
we got a penalty on us, probably
C.J. Scott spreading out to the right, and it is against LaGrange.
We had a little movement while everybody was trying to get set. I think one of the Granger players jumped.
Brings up third down and 16. They're spreading it out again, same formation. Under center, hands it off to Lee, and oh, had a big hole. Kendrick did that just closed up around the.
We got a late flag.
Extracurricular activity.
I think we'll get a late personal foul on this, maybe.
What happened there, Cal? I didn't see
it. Just a couple of players shoving each other. But the referees, I agree with the referee. You got to establish the control even on those little minor skirmishes.
Yep. As a soccer referee, I agree 100%. Sometimes you got to call the little things first to keep from having to call big things later.
Right.
Dead ball. Unsportsmanlike against Callaway. And that's it.
15-yard.
Not both ways, so it's going to be a 15-yard penalty, and LaGrange got the first down by the penalty route.
Boy, what a killer penalty. Your defensive's just stopped him on three consecutive plays, and you give up a dumb penalty like that.
Our guys did not respond, so that was to their credit.
Crawford hands the ball off to Miles Johnson, who gets maybe a foot on the play. Actually, this judge over here is going to walk it back, so he's going to lose a foot on the play.
Yeah, that the buck sweep, which is the old Granger bread and butter play, didn't quite get everything blocked over there on the right side, but just like that fullback in the flats a while ago, Tommy, I think they'll come back to that buck sweep.
Yeah, that was our bread and butter for years.
Crawford's under center. Going to hand the ball off to Cornell Kendrick, who shuffles his feet, gets forward up to about the, it looked like he got to the 48. They're going to mark it the 47.
He was about 2 feet from breaking that into a big gain. When he ran through the hole, if he'd have broke a little bit left, he would have had some more running room. But that's the play right there, that 58 gut where you hand the ball off to the fullback straight up the middle.
C.J. Scott comes off. Swanson goes on. Third and nine. One receiver left, one right. Backs in a double wing. Going to hand the ball off to Kendrick, and the Cavaliers snuffed that one out and stopped it for about a yard loss to the 45.
Callaway doing a good job up front. That defensive line is starting to take over a little bit on the battle up front.
The long snapper on this punt attempt is number 62, Christian Whaley, a junior. And I'll tell you a little bit about him if I have a chance. I saw him at the Heard County game. LaGrange had 4th and 10 from their own one, and he had a snap that hit the punter right in the chest, and that was a good snap there. Good punt to the 20, the 25, 30. 35 slows them up, still makes a move to the 40,
fumble.
Down to the 41-yard line.
Got a fumble.
And Granger say they have it, and the referee says they have it!
Jaquavius Bowles.
Jaquavius Bowles and Cornell Kendrick on the hit. What a great hit to knock the ball loose.
6:39 left to go in the first quarter. And LaGrange has the ball, 1st and 10, inside Callaway territory at the 41. And we saw last year, I mean, just about every time a drive starts inside the opponent's territory, points get scored. Let's see if that happens here.
LaGrange lining up really tight.
Crawford under center. Swanson on the left side. They're going to throw it to him, and it is overthrown and intercepted.
Intercepted by
number 4, Kobe Jackson, at their own 15-yard line.
Yeah, just a bit of an overthrow. The receiver got mistracked, and the defensive back, Kobe Jackson, just made a spectacular play, fading back and catching that ball on the run.
That's just good defensive play.
Really had him covered well. The route could have been run a little bit better, but still it was good a defensive play by the Callaway.
Callaway has the ball first and 10. The pitch to the running back, to the 15, to the 20, and drop there. The quarterback is Kendrick Ramsey, the senior.
Option to the left side, covered really well by the Granger defense. As long as you keep making that quarterback pitch the ball, you're going to have a good night defending that triple option.
Backs in the I formation. The pitch. And he's going to get dragged down. Well, he started to get dragged down to the 20. He just fell forward down to about the 23-yard line. And I'm having a hard time seeing the number of that running back. I'll get to it in just a minute.
Taj Hickson on the tackle. Bringing up a third and short.
A little over a yard, right at a yard.
Cavaliers come to the line of scrimmage. Ramsey goes under center.
And they move.
Yep, I saw some movement there. That's going to back them up 5 yards. And that's got to make the coach's hair turn gray when you got a third and a yard. Now it's a third and 6.
You know, I saw the Granger defensive line, a couple of the players jumping around. I don't think they were trying to draw the offense offside. It was just that they got to jumping around, and I think one of them enticed the offensive player to move.
Yeah, that wasn't the old Donnie Branch special we saw with the defensive shift. But
yeah, down on the goal line, you got to we had the shift call.
Mm-hmm. Worked just about every time.
Turn a lot of first plays from the 1 back to the 6.
Mm-hmm. So third down and 6. Ramsey rolling out, throwing, tipped, beautiful! Number 21 for the Grangers, Vondez Taylor, a sophomore, getting a finger on it, and the ball falls harmlessly to the turf, fourth down.
Saved a completion right there.
And it was good pursuit by 58, Jahan Warrens, putting pressure on the quarterback to have him throw it erratically.
Cavaliers back to punt. Standing with his toes on his own 5-yard line. And there's the punt.
Shank.
Yeah, big time shank. It's like one of my golf shots, except for it went a lot farther than that. So the Grangers with the ball, first and 10. We'll take a quick 30-second break. No score here in the first quarter. This is LaGrange High Granger football on the Eagle Sports Network.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at RE/MAX Results, because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
Now back to LaGrange Granger football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Break, or is this a charge timeout?
They have gone to a hydration break now.
Don't blame them. We're going to keep it right here, and then I don't blame them for the hydration break. We were told, I've got 4 soccer games I've got to referee tomorrow in Peachtree City, and we're told halfway between each half, mandatory minimum 2 minutes hydration break for the teams. And the fourth game I've got, it's a U11 game involving the Troop Titans Travel League here out of LaGrange.
So, oh, yeah?
That should be fun.
Yeah.
That should be a good one. I know that, I don't know who the head coach is over there. He probably just rolled his eyes right now saying, oh, I got Michael Buchanan, really? Sorry, coach. First and 10 for the Grangers from the Callaway 44-yard line here in the first quarter. Miles Johnson will get nowhere. He ran to the right side and got to the 48-yard line, loss of four.
Oh, that was a jet sweep running from left to right, and we just didn't quite get the blocking on the end that we needed. Callaway doing a good job of penetrating on that side to stop the jet sweep.
Yeah, Callaway's got a really good defensive line. They're very disciplined in that. We're going to have to really attack them strategically.
Second and 14. Going to fake the jet sweep this time. Unfortunately, Charles Crawford kept it himself and just got bottled up. One player on that defensive line followed Johnson. The rest of them stayed at home and made the play.
Yeah, it looked like a busted play. Half the players ran one play and the other half ran another play. And that play was bad, doomed from the start.
Third down and 15. One receiver left, one receiver right. Crawford under center. Back to pass, straight drop, slowed up. He's going to have to tuck it and run, and he does. Gets some good yardage up to about the 42-yard line, but still a long way to go for a first down, about 8 yards.
Yeah, you just cut your losses. Callaway doing a good job of defending in the secondary. No one to throw to, and when you decide to tuck it and run, just get what you can for your punter.
Look like we're going to...
If this close, we're going to go for it, Tommy.
I don't see the punting team out there.
Yeah, they're going to go for it.
Got about 7 yards to go. Let's see what will happen.
Rolling the dice.
Swanson split out to the right side. Everybody else in. Kendrick throws it against the grain. He's going to throw it to C.J. Scott. He's got the 40. Ball came loose and is out of bounds about the 43-yard line. So Callaway will start first and 10 there.
It was a sprint. Looked like a sprint out to the right to begin with, but we had a screen pass back to the left. And, you know, Callaway's just doing a great job of staying at home and defending your little area of territory. You're not fooling anybody right now.
Callaway's got a good team, and they're showing why. 2:16 left to go in the first quarter. No score. Cavaliers with the ball first and 10 from their own 43. I think they only had, one loss last year going into the playoff. One loss, and that was in the playoffs. Rolling out to his left, number 14. 14, Cartavius Bigsby for the Cavaliers on the sweep to the left side. He'll get about 3 yards.
Number 23 for the Grangers, Taj Hickson, he was fixing to make a play.
He got a little held up.
It looked like he got tackled, Tommy.
He did. Coach was going wild on the side. Hold and hold, tackle.
Yeah, he was fixing to make a play on the ball.
He didn't get a penalty for holding because he wasn't held. He was tackled, which is still illegal. One receiver left, one right. Backs in the I formation. Ramsey under center. Going to give the ball to the 50. He may have the first down. It's going to be close. Bigsby again. And they're going to say move the chains.
First down.
To the 47.
That looked pretty close right there. The referees are more sure of it than I was.
Thing is, I'm looking right down the 47-yard line, and if it was, it was just the nose of the football. Cavaliers come to the line of scrimmage. Two receivers to the right side.
Oh, you got a lonely.
Got
a lonely out here.
Yeah, but it's going to give it to the running back. That is number 15, Quay Hines. And he gets maybe a yard. Yeah, there was 15, one DB covering two wide receivers. The quarterback didn't see it. The plan play apparently was a run game. And instead of getting 6 points, they got 1 yard.
And Deshaun Aldridge come up and made a great tackle on that.
Second Second down and 9. One receiver left, one right. Ramsey under center. And he's going to fake the give to the fullback, pitch it to the running back, who's going to get hit at the 40-yard line, then driven back hard. Quay Hines with the ball and then forcefully getting planted to the ground.
DeAndre Towns with a big hit. Did you see that, Tommy?
He just it looked like a little Wesley Wood that hit over there. Way Wesley used to coming in.
Man, he, back there at that safety spot, he got him about a 15-yard head start and just laid the guy out.
That's the end of the first quarter with your score. Nothing as we go to the second quarter of play. We'll be back after this one-minute break. This is LaGrange High Granger Football on the Eagles Sports Network.
Here's Perry Prather, head pharmacist at Holmes Pharmacy.
The joy of coming into work in pharmacy every day is to interact with the patients, get a feel for them, understand them, love them, first of all. You got to love your patients. You got to love people. That's what we do. As a person and as a business, that's my thing. Is that I want to give them the exceptional care. Everybody is going to come to you that we care about and they feel like this is home.
HomesPharmacy.com. Granger and Hamilton.
There's a secret to beating injuries or ailments. Get the right team. Emory Southern Orthopedics, well-trained, experienced doctors, nurses, and staff are that team. These teammates listen and understand your specific condition and provide high-quality hometown care that will get you back into your game. For more information about Emory Southern Orthopedics team, visit www.southernorthopedics.com.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Callaway Cavaliers come to the line of scrimmage facing third down and around 3 yards to go. Ramsey under center. One receiver, Courtney Williams, is to the left side. Can't see the number for the one on the right. Ramsey's going to hand it off to the running back who gets tripped up. And then dropped. He will get the first down. That was number one, DJ Atkins, on the carry. It would have been a whole lot more, but he got stumbled there early on before he falls forward for the first down. To the 36-yard line.
Yeah, Robert Thornton made a good play getting to the ball because right off the snap, he was getting double teamed. And he fought through the double team to get to that ball.
One receiver left, one right. Backs in the I formation. Ramsey comes to the line under center. He's going to pitch it to the running back who is brought down. They're going to say, no, he's not.
They will not blow the whistle. They did not blow the whistle.
I'll be honest, I don't think he was down. He was rolled over the defender and got back up a la, what was that Auburn player's name?
Michael Dyer,
that's right. Kind of like that. But then he was held up, and it was obvious he wasn't going to go any farther. Then they blew the whistle.
Dexter Fitzpatrick made a great cut. They didn't fool him at all.
All the way back to the 47-yard line. Second and 21. Ramsey's going to be out of the shotgun over his head. Now he gets the ball back, and he's going to direct traffic and try to get some yards on his own, and he's going to get the first down.
He's just an athlete.
All the way down to the 20-yard line. He just pointed and said, you block him, and he got the blocking he needed for the first down. A totally busted play that worked.
And he's a little gimpy right now.
To the 23-yard line, a 24-yard gain by Kendrick Ramsey.
A good, good individual effort.
Tip your hat to that young man. First and 10, no score. Two receivers left, backs in the eye. They're giving the ball to Atkins once again, straight up the middle. He's got the first down, the parting of the Red Sea right there in front of him. In this case, the Blue Sea. and lots of room to run and got down to the 10.
Great job of just bulldogging up the middle.
Ramsey's definitely limping over there. He's
this is a goal at the 10-yard line.
We call timeout.
Timeout called. We'll pause 30 seconds plus 10 for station identification. No score here at Callaway Stadium. This is LaGrange High Granger football on the Eagles Sports Network.
LaGrange Banking is growing. We've opened a new location in Columbus, and we've adopted a new name that reflects our community roots with an eye on the future. Welcome to Calumet Bank, offering personal and business banking services with the friendliness of neighbors. We work on your schedule, offering daytime business hours and a complete set of mobile apps. Day or night, we've got you covered. Calumet Bank, same great services from people you already know. Life is better at Calumet. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
You're listening to LaGrange Grangers Football on WCJM FM West Point 100.9 The Bull. Tonight's game is brought to you in part by Holmes Pharmacy and Mallory Insurance.
Back to Callaway Stadium. The Grangers bowing their backs against this Callaway Cavalier offense, who, in all fairness, has been on busted plays and pure athleticism is how they've been getting down here. They've got first and goal to the 10-yard line inside Granger territory.
It is one thing to play your responsibility and play it right, but you just can't overcome that talent sometimes.
Now number 12, Chandler Lott, is the quarterback, and he's going to hand the ball off. A helmet comes flying off of Granger.
Jacoby Williams made a great play on that, but unfortunately lost his helmet, and he'll have to step out for a play.
Oh, I forgot about that rule. You are correct. You are absolutely correct.
Jacoby Smith. I said Williams. I'm sorry.
Down to the 9-yard line.
Now, Callaway probably saw number 10 coming off the field. I would expect a play toward his replacement.
Mondarius Beasley's over here on the right corner over there, and he's lined up against number 2, DQ Wilkerson.
Second goal just inside the 10. Ramsey's back out there. And they're going to hand the ball off up the middle, and he's going to get dropped. Number 15, Quay Hines, gets about 5 yards, but that's it. Third down.
Deshaun Archer's in on the stop on that.
Callaway insisting on pounding up the middle down here deep.
Third and goal, and they got the ball on the left hash mark over here, right inside the left hash mark.
Here we go. Ramsey under center, backs in the I formation. Going to pitch to the running back, who gets slowed up, but he escapes one tackle, but does not escape another one. He's going to be dropped at the 6-yard line.
A great call on the defensive part, stopping the sweep dead in the tracks.
They pitched to Hines, and Hines was stopped, but he squirted free and cut it back inside. That was enough for the rest of the Grangers to come bottle him up.
That's the play that drives a defensive coordinator crazy, is he got a primary hit in the backfield. He escapes and gets 2 or 3 yards.
24-yard field goal attempt. The snap, the spot, the kick. It's up. It's on its way. It is good. Timeout on the field. 7:42 left to go in the first quarter. It's Callaway 3, LaGrange nothing. Excuse me, second quarter, rather. Callaway 3, LaGrange nothing. Back after this one-minute break. This is Granger football on the Eagles Sports Network.
Tara, are you okay?
Yes, I can't believe you found me. I have car trouble, and there you are.
Yeah, that's State Farm's 24/7 access.
It's like we have this mental telepathy, you know?
Well, you did start filing your claim with your mobile device. You can access State Farm on your phone, online, even in person at one of the 18,000 neighborhood
State Farm offices. See? Mental telepathy.
State Farm is there for you anytime, anywhere. Get to a better state. State Farm.
Connect telepathically with Agent Matt Orr on the square in downtown LaGrange.
When it comes to your health, nobody beats the home team at WellStar West Georgia Medical Center. Named number one large hospital by Georgia Trend Magazine. Nationally ranked a top 100 hospital by Truven Health. And one of the 100 great community hospitals by Becker's Hospital Review. WellStar West Georgia Medical Center is your award-winning team in LaGrange. Visit wellstar.org/WGMC to learn more. We believe in life well lived.
Now back to LaGrange Wager Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Callaway Cavaliers get from their own 43 to the 6-yard line of the Grangers, but get no farther. A 24-yard field goal, and it's 3-0 Callaway. Now LaGrange will start first and 10 from their own 20.
This Noah Stevens is quite the impressive kicker. He's kicked three into the end zone two into the end zone already.
Yep. It's a hard, and it's also a hard ball to catch the way he kicks it.
It's a knuckleball, isn't it?
It's weird.
Crawford hands the ball off of that Callaway defense, penetrating right in there on Cornell Kendrick, and looks like it's going to be about a yard loss.
Jonathan Leonard coming up to make the stop. Just it was as if he just walked right on through the line.
He got quick penetration on there. They're very quick and athletic on that defensive line.
Swanson going in for C.J. Scott. And everybody tight in. Nobody split out that I can see. Nope.
Jet sweep.
Yeah, Miles is going to try to turn that corner. He gets a few yards out of it to about the 23-yard line, Miles Johnson.
Picked it up about five, got to the 24. Got third and six.
He gets a good block out here on the end. I think that's
he got some speed.
That's Tyrese Thornton on the block on that side that sealed the jet sweep for him.
Swanson now splitting off to the left side. Third down. Rangers trailing by three. Back to pass. Throws it for Swanson. Incomplete. I thought he got hit before the ball got there, but no yellow hankies. Fourth down.
It was close.
Very close.
It was close, but over there on that sideline, you're probably not going to get that call.
I'm Michael Buchanan. Cal Hires sitting immediately to my right. Tommy Whitworth on the sideline. Tucker Browning's our producer. Taylor Sears running the board back in the studio. Glad to have you with us from Callaway Stadium as the Cavaliers lead 3-0. LaGrange set the punt. Good snap. Good punt. High end over end punt. Fielded at the 45-yard line. Fair caught by D.Q. Wilkerson. And the Cavaliers will start first and 10 there.
Matt Rainey done a good job punting the ball tonight.
Yeah, that was a good punt and good protection up front. We looked like we had some leakage, but for the most part, we had pretty good protection for the punter.
Cavaliers lead 3-0, and we'll have the ball first and 10, just a little bit past their 45-yard line with 6 minutes and 4 seconds to go in the half. One receiver right, one left. Backs in the eye. Ramsey under center. He's going to hand it to the fullback who is spilled at the 50-yard line. Let me get his number here. 29. Can't tell. That's silver on white. I'm going to say 28. Jalen Shepard, and he's a freshman. Listed as a running back. I only say that because 29 is listed as a wide receiver. They get to the midfield stripe. Second down, one receiver right, one left. Going to hand it off to the running back who the Grangers have plugged every hole he had a chance to get through. and Atkins goes nowhere for a loss of one.
Hey, that was a great job. I'm going to call the whole defensive line for the Grangers on that one, along with number 33. Who is number 33 right there? I don't have any
Smith. Who?
Jaquez Smith.
Jaquez. Okay. Excellent job of sealing up the hole.
I got to put him on. He wasn't on the roster, Coach.
Robert Thornton was right in the middle. Good effort by the whole defense.
Third down and 7. Two receivers to the left side.
I think they moved a little early or something.
Yeah, the Grangers didn't break the plane. Yeah, the near judge over here is pointing to the Cavaliers. The Grangers are clapping, and that's going to be 5 yards.
Huge difference.
Yeah, 3rd and 7 is bad enough, but by my math, 3rd and 12 is worse.
5 yard penalty. Give the ball back to the 42-yard line. It'll be 3rd down and 12.
So 3rd down for the Cavaliers, leading 3-0.
It's such a wonderful feel on this sideline with everybody focused. The whole team's up focused.
2 receivers left, 2 right. Back to pass, Ramsey. Starting to feel some pressure. Down he goes. Ball's on the ground. Picked up by the aforementioned Jaquez Smith. And the Grangers have the ball inside the 30-yard line of the Cavaliers.
A great penetration by the defensive end. The quarterback never saw the defender coming, and it was a great hit, a great safe hit at that. I didn't see him leap with the head or anything, but he knocked the ball loose. Now, that's the old Granger defense.
I was just about to say that. You know Kenny Moore is smiling about that.
Yes, he is. Donnie Branch, you would have been proud.
From the 28-yard line to the Cavaliers, 1st and 10 Grangers. Charles Crawford hands it off to Cornell Kendrick, who bowls his way across the 25-yard line to the 23.
You see, one great play like that can make a big difference in the energy level.
Good for 5 yards on the play.
I think second the only five. Bad thing that can happen now is referees call it water break.
Yeah, we hadn't had a water break this quarter yet.
We move.
Yeah. Snap count was on 2. Some folks went on 1.
Coach Frank Caputo about to blow a gasket on that.
And that negates that gain that Kendrick just got.
Yes, it does. That's tough.
Coach Burke said in the pregame interview and even before that, before we started the tape rolling, that the hardest part last year, just a few plays away from being 5-5, a penalty on a big run called back, a bad turnover here, just stuff like that that'll just drive you crazy.
It drives everybody crazy.
2nd and 10. Crawford hands it off to Miles. He had a lot of room before one player grabbed an ankle like a bear trap and wouldn't let go until he got help, and he did get help. He got to the 26 for about a 2-yard gain, but could have been a lot more.
It was an inside reverse handoff where everybody's flowing left, and here he comes to the right with one blocker right in front of him. If we get that one little block where he can cut it straight up field, we can get good yardage out of it. I bet we come back to that play later.
Yeah, it was, like you say, the one guy didn't bite on it.
Third down and 8.
Big Joe Thornton coming out.
Number 26, yard line.
And number 68 for LaGrange, Dylan Heflin, the sophomore coming in. And LaGrange will take a timeout here. We'll take a 30-second timeout with him. 3:21 left to go in the second quarter. Grangers trail 3-0, but are driving back after this break. This is LaGrange High Granger football on the Eagle Sports Network.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's the step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at RE/MAX Results because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM The Bull.
Granger's facing 3rd and 8, and we were talking up here in the booth. Don't know if Tommy could hear us or not, but about Joe having to come out. Do you know anything about that?
No, he's back in right now.
Okay, good.
Yeah, that's why that's why we called the timeout, was able to get him fixed up and put him back in there, because I bet we run right there.
One receiver left, Crawford, under center. Going to fake to Kendrick. He's going to throw it to Miles Johnson, who, instead of turning straight upfield and going,
they called him down.
Okay, he got dropped around the 21-yard line, about 3 yards short. Ball came loose, but it was after he touched the ground.
Way on the other side over there. It's hard for me to tell if they would. He was close to that end line over there.
Yeah, he had a chance to cut it straight up the field to get big yardage, but he did what we call too much dancing around.
Yeah. Instead of just cutting up field and going. So now this is going to be a 40-yard field goal attempt by Matt Rainey from the left hash mark. Long snapper is Christian Whaley. The holder, Kobe Patton. Snap, spot, kick.
Blocked.
It is blocked. Blocked, picked up, and going the other way is number 2, D.Q. Wilkerson.
Oh, what a momentum killer. You're about to score on one end of the field, and all of a sudden the other team scores on the other side of the field. This is going to be a hiccup that we're going to have to just play through now.
Yep. It was blocked. Let's see. The ball was spotted at the 30, so it's been a 40-yard attempt. And Wilkerson, he got blocked and picked up and gone 70 yards for the touchdown. Callaway lining up for the extra points. 36, Noah Stevens. Snap, spot, kick, up, count it. Timeout of the field. 2:09 left to go in the first half. Callaway extends the lead to 10-0. We'll be back after this 1 minute break. This is LaGrange High, Granger Football on the Eagles Sports Network.
There's a secret to beating injuries or ailments. Get the right team. Emory Southern Orthopedics, well-trained, experienced doctors, nurses, and staff are that team. These teammates listen and understand your specific condition and provide high-quality hometown care that will get you back into your game. For more information about Emory's Southern Orthopedic Team, visit www.southernorthopedics.com. Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So to take a step in the right direction, contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at RE/MAX Results because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM The Bull.
Field goal attempt by D.Q. Wilkerson. Extra point is good, 10-0. The kick goes into the end zone, but it's going to have to come back. They were offside.
Looks like he's setting up for a sky kick over here on the right side. Who's at number 17? LaQuincy better be awake.
You are correct. There it is, a sky kick. And it is fielded by number 10.
Jacoby.
Jacoby lost his helmet again.
Yeah, he did. He needs to strap that thing on a good bit tighter than that. But he did keep on with the ball. And he's got, now the Grangers have the ball first and 10 at their own 37-yard line.
I wonder what the time of possession is in this first half. We have held it 75-80% of the time. And
well, the first two drives, including the fumble on the return, the Grangers had the ball 5 minutes and 27 seconds before the Callaway offense got out there. So you're probably right there, Tommy. Hand off to Cornell Kendrick, who gets maybe a yard loss to the 36-yard line. And they add that up.
Well, this defensive line for Callaway is just some kind of tough right now to run against.
You would think we would be wearing them down as much as they've been out on the field, but it's apparent they're in good shape also.
That's right, Tommy. This time of the year, your big guys up front usually take a toll of the punishment. There's that little inside reverse again.
Yeah, gets up to the line of scrimmage and not much else. That's number 7 for the Grange, Trez Delaney on the carry. Started right and then took the handoff left.
Callaway calls a timeout to try to get the ball. They're going to try to get the ball back before the half.
5:27, and then LaGrange added another 2:22. Then LaGrange added a minute 40. Another 2 minutes, 10 seconds. So yeah, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I would say 11 minutes. Yeah, Callaway had that one long drive, so about balanced out. About 11 minutes. Yeah, it's about 12 minutes each is probably what it's going to wind up being for time of possession.
Yeah, first quarter we had definitely, and then the second quarter they did have that long that they got the field goal out of.
Cavaliers lead 10-0 with a minute 17 left to go in the half. Grange with the ball, 3rd and 10. One receiver left, 2 right.
3rd down and 10 for the Grangers of the 37.
Crawford under center. Kendrick in the backfield. Crawford's going to throw it, and he's going to overthrow everybody. And I mean everybody. Intended for number 11, Jordan Ogletree. Now the Grangers will have to punt.
Just a good overthrow, if you want to ever call an incomplete pass a good throw. He wasn't open, and Charles just had to put it somewhere where nobody could catch it.
He was well covered.
Yeah, double covered. Take off the sunglasses now as the fireball is gone behind the trees.
Rainey
keeping his knees up. It was a low snap. He does get it off. And it's going to check up to around the 38-yard line of the Cavaliers. So Callaway will start first and 10 there.
1 minute, 2 seconds.
Yes, sir. Cavs with a 10-0 lead. And
Granger defense is going to have to be ready for any kind of little trick play, any kind of screen or something that's going to get designed for big yardage.
They gave up 2 big plays against Hearn County last year. Now, mind you, their quarterback is better than Callaway's, but Callaway's got a pretty good quarterback, though.
Yes, they do.
He's rolling out to his right, Ramsey is. He's going to uncork it. Long, deep, and caught at the 15. And he is in for the touchdown. Oh, my God. Gordon Williams, with the catch from Kendrick Payne and Ramsey.
Yeah, and it was a great throw to start with, but the Granger defender's right there on top of it. I think he even had it at one time, but just got it taken away from him.
Had double coverage on him, basically.
How did he catch that ball, Tommy?
It looked like he just reached up and took it away from us.
Okay, because I thought we had intercepted it.
Extra point attempt is up, and it's good. 50 seconds left to go here in the second half, first half. I'm in preseason form myself, apparently.
The first half, your score.
And it is now 17-0. Cavaliers with the lead. We're going to keep it right here because we are caught up on commercials. Cal, Grangers were down 3-0 and recovered a fumble inside Cavalier territory and looked like they were really, really ready to go. And then the momentum just shifted like a wrecking ball.
Right now we got some leaks in the dam. We got to find a way to plug them up right now and just get into halftime. We need to get the ball right here and move it however way we can and try to, of course try to score, but we also want to keep the ball until halftime. We don't want to give it back to the Cavaliers. Here we go with that sky kick again. LaQuincy and Jacoby better be ready for it.
There it is. High sky kick, fielded at the 21. Tried to hurdle a Cavaliers, could not do it. Jacoby Smith holds on to the ball though, so first and 10 for LaGrange. Around the 25.
Kept his helmet on too.
Yeah. Oh, one man between him and the sideline. He tried to jump over him, I guess.
Well, it looked like he was starting to go down. The defender did, and it said he came up. And I don't know how high that is, but I don't think a high hurdler could have tracked that one.
No.
46 seconds left to go in the half. And there's that jet sweep to the right side, but nothing doing. Number 24, LaGrange, Andre Canty, the sophomore. I tell you, I've been reading these names off, and I'm looking at that there's a lot of names I haven't been calling a whole lot.
That's right.
A lot of sophomores
in this lineup. Yeah, I think Coach Burks is just wanting to get into halftime to make some adjustments.
Yep, I think you're right. 8 seconds, 7 seconds, 6 seconds. Everybody's just standing around. That's going to be the end.
I think second half we're going to bring us out a big surprise.
That's the end of the first half with your score. Callaway 17 and LaGrange nothing.
It's Callaway 17 and your Rangers of LaGrange.
Callaway scoring.
I got Coach Burks here for first comment.
Go ahead.
Coach, scoreboard looks horrible, but the effort other than a couple of plays has been really good.
Well, we just got to eliminate mistakes. 17 points, that's two scores and a field goal, so it's a lot of game left. A
lot of game. We're going to just have to get up and get ready for the second half. Any new wrinkles we're going to try second half, you think?
Well, we just got to get going on offense. We one guy away. We one guy away. In our blocking scheme, whether it's up front or on the edge. So we just got to make sure we're doing our jobs. We're fine.
Thank you, Coach. Good luck second half.
Thank you.
Your score at the half, LaGrange trailing the Callaway Cavaliers 17-0. We'll tell you how we got there when we come back after this two-minute break. This is LaGrange High Granger football on the Eagles Sports Network.
Here's Perry Prather, head pharmacist at Holmes Pharmacy.
Joy of coming into work at the pharmacy every day is to interact with the patients, get a feel for them, understand them, love them. First of all, you got to love your patients. You got to love people. That's what we do. And as a person and as a business, that's my thing. I want to give them the exceptional care. Everybody that comes in here that we care about, and they feel like this is home to them when they come in.
homepharmacy.com in LaGrange and Hamilton.
LaGrange Banking is growing. We've opened a new location in Columbus, and we've adopted a new name that reflects our community roots with an eye on the future. Welcome to Calumet Bank, offering personal and business banking services with the friendliness of neighbors. We work on your schedule, offering daytime business hours and a complete set of mobile apps. Day or night, we've got you covered. Calumet Bank, same great services from people you already know. Life is better at Calumet. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Tara, are you okay?
Yes, I can't believe you found me. I have car trouble and there you are.
Yeah, that's State Farm's 24/7 access.
It's like we have this mental telepathy, you know?
Well, you did start filing your claim with your mobile device. You can access State Farm on your phone, online, even in person at one of the 18,000 neighborhood
State Farm offices. See? Mental telepathy.
State Farm is there for you anytime, anywhere. Get to a better state. State Farm.
Connect telepathically with Agent Matt Orr on the square in downtown LaGrange. There's a secret to beating injuries or ailments. Get the right team. Emory Southern Orthopedics, well-trained, experienced doctors, nurses, and staff are that team. These teammates listen and understand your specific condition and provide high-quality hometown care that will get you back into your game. For more information about Emory Southern Orthopedics team, visit www.southernorthopedics.com.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM The Bull.
17-0 here at the half. Callaway Cavaliers with the lead. Let's tell you how we got there. First, the Grangers, Cavaliers deferred to the second half, so LaGrange will receive. They got the ball at their own 20-yard line. Got all the way down to the 45 before they had to punt. Punted away they did, and Callaway fumbled the ball on the return. So LaGrange had the ball first and 10 at the Cavalier 41-yard line. But the first play from scrimmage, an interception thrown by Charles Crawford, and Callaway gets the ball at their own 15-yard line. Cavaliers go three and out, though, on their first drive and have to punt the ball away. LaGrange starting at the Callaway 44-yard line. But then, unfortunately, they go four and out, turning the ball over on downs. Callaway getting the ball at the 43-yard line, and they have a sustained drive. Four first downs, 12 plays. But then the drive stalls at the Granger's 6-yard line. They settle for a 3 points by a 24-yard field goal by Noah Stevens. See, that's what I get for trying to read my own handwriting. Noah Stevens. Thank you. And it is 3-0 Callaway. LaGrange then goes 3 and out, punting the ball away. And again, Callaway's next drive, they fumble the ball, and LaGrange has it at the Callaway 28-yard line. Down 3 points, first and 10 on Callaway's 28-yard line. And on fourth down, a blocked field goal returned by DQ Wilkerson for the touchdown. And all of a sudden, the momentum starts coming the other way. It's 10-0 Cavaliers. LaGrange then goes three and out, puts the ball away. Cavaliers only need one play, a 62-yard pass from Ramsey to Williams. More points on the board. Extra point is good. 17-0 Cavaliers. Thankfully, it's halftime now. That momentum can stop, take a breath, and now LaGrange can come out and hopefully get a three and out, because Callaway will get the ball first the second half and try to get some momentum back.
Yeah, this will tell the character of the LaGrange Grangers that, you know, if we can come out of halftime and like you said, get a three and out and get the momentum shifted back toward the blue side, I believe we can make a good game out of it. It's just like Coach Burke says, we got to eliminate the mistakes. We're one block, we're one man away from several big plays in the first half. And once we take care of that business, we can control the ball, and hopefully control the clock and score these 18 points that we're going to need to come away with a W.
You know, except for the one big play and one long pass play, the Granger defense has actually looked pretty decent.
They have, Michael. The defensive line play's been good. The linebackers are running from side to side making plays. Dexter Fitzpatrick's doing a good job. Several times we've called the what's the young man's name, number 33, what was it?
Jacquez Smith.
Okay.
Again, trying to read my own handwriting there.
Yeah.
I'll have it printed out tomorrow.
Okay. But, you know, the young man's been playing really well tonight. And, you know, it's just going to take 11 players pulling together to get ourselves back into this game. And, like I said, it's going to be a true character test.
You're absolutely correct. Well, it is 17-0 here at the half. When we come back, we'll see if we can get you some scores of games going on today. One barn burner of a game happened here at Callaway Stadium last night. We'll tell you a bit about that as well. But right now, 17-0 Callaway with the lead. Hopefully not for long. We'll be back after this two-minute break. This is LaGrange High Granger football on the Eagle Sports Network.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at REMAX Results because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
When it comes to your health, nobody beats the home team at WellStar West Georgia Medical Center. Named number one large hospital by Georgia Trend magazine. Nationally ranked a top 100 hospital by Truven Health. And one of the 100 great community hospitals by Becker's Hospital Review. WellStar West Georgia Medical Center is your award-winning team in LaGrange. Visit wellstar.org/WGMC to learn more. We believe in life well lived.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at REMAX Results because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
Here's Perry Prather, head pharmacist at Holmes Pharmacy.
The joy of coming into work in the pharmacy every day is to interact with the patients, get a feel for them, understand them, love them, first of all. You got to love your patients. You got to love people. That's what we do as a person and as a business. That's my thing is I want to give them an exceptional care. Everybody that comes in here that we care about, and they feel like this is home to them.
HolmesPharmacy.com in Granger and Hamilton.
Now back to LaGrange Granger football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Back again at Callaway Stadium, 17-0 Cavaliers with the lead over the LaGrange Grangers. Last night here at Callaway Stadium, the Troop Tigers had a barn burner. 31-28 was the final score of the Tigers over Hardaway. Was not here for the game. I read about it in the LaGrange Daily News, and that was just an absolute heck of a game. What a way to start out the season.
Yeah, how many touchdowns is that?
That would be at least 8 plus a field goal total.
That's
awesome. Cartersville is at Allatoona, and the Purple Hurricanes are leading Allatoona at the half, 21-7. Cedartown is leading Rockmart. They're hosting Rockmart right now. 13-0 at the end of the first quarter is the last score that we have on that so far. Central Carroll is playing at Villa Rica. I don't know if Central Carroll has a radio station or not. If not, they're probably up in the stands like we were, unfortunately. But Villarica leading in the second quarter over Central Carroll, 7-0. And Creekside is at Sandy Creek. Don't have a score yet on that one. We will effort to get one. And Chapel Hill, well, their season actually starts next week. They are open here in week one, getting a little extra breather. They're open. They've got an open date at the beginning of the season. We've got an open date at the end of the season. It all balances out, I guess.
I don't know if I'd like to have that open date at the beginning of the season, because you know how antsy your boys are wanting to play, and having to take the first week off, that would be the pit.
Chapel Hill probably scouting out Fayette County, who they'll be hosting next week. Next week is an interesting lineup. Cherokee County out of Alabama travels to Cedartown. Landmark Christian is at Central Carroll. Fayette County at Chapel Hill. The Grangers will host the Villarica Wildcats here at Callaway Stadium next Friday night. Airtime is at 7 o'clock. And Saturday, Bertram Trail out of Florida, and I think that's out of the Jacksonville area, is traveling all the way up to Cartersville to play on a Saturday. So that should be interesting. Another Saturday game, Troop is playing at Kendrick. Muskogee County has a football classic or some kind of a spectacular at Kinnett Stadium. Four games, 11 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 5 o'clock, and 8 o'clock. $10 will get you in the door, and you can watch all four games if you can stand being in the heat
for
that long a time. But Troop Tigers have the matinee at Kendrick at 11 o'clock Saturday morning. And then Sandy Creek and the Callaway Cavaliers have an open date next week.
Now, when Villarica comes over, Michael, you're not going to make them sit out in the stands, are you?
I hope it rains and they're on top of the press box. That's what I hope. About 7 minutes left to go here in the half. It is 17-0. The Callaway Cavaliers leading LaGrange. Also, before I let you go, I want to remind you that this broadcast of Granger football is authorized under the rights granted to Eagles Nest Incorporated by LaGrange High School. It's intended solely for the entertainment of our listening audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this broadcast without the express written consent of LaGrange High School is prohibited. 17-0, Callaway with the lead. We'll be back after this two-minute break. This is LaGrange High Granger football on the Eagles Sports Network.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at REMAX Results, because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
There's a secret to beating injuries or ailments. Get the right team. Emory Southern Orthopedics, well-trained, experienced doctors, nurses, and staff are that team. These teammates listen and understand your specific condition and provide high-quality hometown care that will get you back into your game. For more information about Emory Southern Orthopedics team, visit www.southernorthopedics.com.
Tara, are you okay?
Yes, I can't believe you found me. I have car trouble and there you are.
Yeah, that's State Farm's 24/7 access.
It's like we have this mental telepathy, you know?
Well, you did start filing your claim with your mobile device. You can access State Farm on your phone, online, even in person at one of the 18,000 neighborhood
State Farm offices. See? Mental telepathy.
State Farm is there for you anytime, anywhere. Get to a better state. State Farm.
Connect telepathically with Agent Matt Orr on the square in downtown LaGrange. Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at Remax Results because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
I got a couple of updated scores for you. It is now 20-6, Cedartown over Rockmart. That game midway through the second quarter. And Sandy Creek has made it to halftime and shutting out Creekside right now, 21-0. And I should be more prepared than this. I've got some notes here about Cartersville's new running back. Remember, we had Creamer for Cartersville last year. He's graduated, thank goodness. But Creekside is surely missing their here it is. Creekside is sorely missing their running back, Rico Fry. He played for Stars Mill his freshman and sophomore years, played for Creekside his junior year. They're sure wishing they had him against Sandy Creek because he transferred to Cartersville. He and his 4,886 yards rushing in 3 years,
wow,
55 touchdowns, and guess what? We get to see him here when Cartersville comes to town.
Have they still got the quarterback?
They still got the quarterback.
Oh, double trouble.
I remember that. Oh my! I don't know why I was thinking he was a senior. Maybe I was hoping he was a senior.
Yeah, I was hoping.
I was telling you that that I'd love to send him a graduation card saying I'm glad you're gone. And you said, "You mean next year?" I'm like, "Oh crud! He's just a junior. We got to see him again." The PA guy out there at Cartersville cracked up when I said that. Yeah, we get to see the. They jokingly call him Sunshine because he looks like Sunshine,
yeah,
from Remember the Titans. Dadgum, yeah. He throws the ball like him too. So,
yeah, I tell you what, and his backup is a photocopy of him.
Yeah, yeah.
You know that program, that Cartersville program, is sure enough established as one of the top programs in the state as far as being able to develop players. And it's sure showing on these players they have coming up now.
Getting a transfer from Creekside doesn't help matters either.
Why does some people have all the luck?
Looking for Tommy Whitworth on the sideline. There he is. Tommy, what was said there at the
said in the locker room stays in the locker room.
Okay.
No, well.
Oh, wait, that's happened before.
Yeah, well, it was pretty intense. Two plays, and it's a three-point game, as we've said.
Yeah.
So, but that's two plays that we lost focus. His main thing was staying focused, staying on blocks, finishing the play, following through. Just the little things, the little things that they got to tighten up on. And I would look for a little more intensity from the offense the second half.
What I had a coach that once said that fundamentals, if you do the fundamentals, the game will be more fun. And that's a corny way of saying it, but it's absolutely true.
It is so true. The more fundamentally sound you are, the less that can go wrong. And that's basically what the Grangers need to have happen right now is play mistake-free football, and that's playing fundamentally sound football.
One thing I've noticed the first half this year is on the bench, on the sideline, watching the games and stuff, we have everybody's watching the game, it seems like. Everybody's into what's going on. And it just seems like there's an air of seriousness more than and a focus. It really is. That's been an encouraging part of it.
Good. Yeah. Like I said in the opening scene center, it seems like the one theme the coaches seem to tell me about this team is that it is a team. It is a big team over little me. And that seems to be the running theme with this team, and that's a good thing. That's a very good thing.
And sometimes something as small as hitting the quarterback and knocking the ball loose, getting the team fired up for about 5 to 7 minutes there, Michael, the Grangers were fired up, ready to knock the ball on into the end zone. But, you know, one mistake deflates the whole momentum thing.
Yep.
And then to give up the long pass play, that also
you could feel it, couldn't you, Cal?
Yeah, yeah.
That's where these players have to have short memories.
That's right, Michael. The best thing to do is just forget about it and to play the next play.
Tommy made me nervous there when he said what happens in the locker room stays in the locker room. And you were there for this. I remember the Perry game. Was it 2003 or 2004?
I think we stayed out of that one.
No, not that one. Not the one. Not at Perry, but it was here. 2003 or 2004.
When DeMario got
ejected. Yes. Yeah. Yes.
The guy punches him. DeMario punches him back, but DeMario gets caught.
And it was a close game, maybe even tied at the half in a game that had no business being tied at the half. LaGrange far outclassed them. And as I recall, Todd Willis, who we saw him earlier saying hi here in the booth, good to see him again. Todd was doing the sideline, and that was the only game where Todd was disinvited from being in the locker room at the half. I don't know what happened in there, but there was some loose paint chips, I understand, on the walls after that. Whoo! They tell you what, though, they came out fist and fire and won that game handily.
Yes, they did. And, you know, the one thing that fired them up was the ejection of DeMario Ford. And, you know, we had a bunch of plays that had DeMario as a big part of the scheme.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden you lose that, and, you know, and it goes back to being fundamentally sound. It didn't matter DeMario got ejected. Weiss played. Everybody still did their job, and DeMario's backup did a tremendous job as well.
Yep.
And, you know, Perry was one of those teams where when you finally got on and started beating them down, you know, they would go on down, but they were really a tough team that night.
Everybody's back on the field as we speak.
We're kicking off, and Callaway's receiving.
Matt Rainey teeing up the ball on his own 40. Back deep for Callaway, looks like number one, DJ Atkins. And we're about underway. The referee blows his Fox 40 classic whistle. And there it is. Here's the kick.
We got offsides.
Yep, I saw a player come across. I was hoping the near side referee didn't. Yep, he's saying offsides. I was hoping he wouldn't see it, but if I saw it, surely they saw it.
And that's one of those discipline things. You know, these are the mistakes that really cost you as far as momentum is concerned. Now we got a little depressed. You know, a little depressed anxiety right now. And
that's one good thing I like about the fact that there's four non-region games before the region schedule, because you got four games to get all these kinks out before the games that count to the playoffs start coming in. So here we go. There's the kick.
Again.
Yep. This time, a player closer to Rainey ran offside instead of one farther out here near the numbers as the first time. And Rainey's going to kick it again, this time from the 30.
Yeah, it's being fundamentally sound. And, you know, this is something you work on at practice. And somebody's fixing to know they're not supposed to be ahead of the kicker when the ball's kicked.
Maybe they ought to stand 10 yards back instead of 5 yards behind Randy.
Back in the old days, we had that letter V where the runners closest to the kicker ran with him.
There we go. Looked like everybody was onside this time. Ball's fielded at the to the 25. Cuts it upfield down to about the 29-yard line.
We got good field position on all that craziness.
Yeah, sure did.
Yeah, good coverage coming down the field. Callaway looked like they had a right return on, and we had every square inch of the field covered really well.
When you hold a kick out, about an 8-yard return on that, that was
And Rainey's just a junior.
Yeah.
He's got time to develop into a really good kicker. He's a pretty good kicker now. One receiver right, one left. Ramsey rolling out. He's going to go for the home run ball. Long throw, and ball falls harmlessly to the turf at the 30-yard line. Double coverage, and this time, well covered. And this receiver is coming up a little bit lame. He's laying down.
I think he fell on that ball. Might have knocked the wind out of him.
I've done that before. Ball point hits you right in the gut. It hurts. And that getting the wind knocked out of you is kind of a scary feeling.
It's heavy wind down here, too, because there ain't no wind. It's just kind of oppressive, sort of. I mean, there's no breeze whatsoever. It's still kind of warm. One of my good buddies said humility is so high.
Air conditioner sure feels good up here, Tom.
Yeah, it does.
I know it does.
I've had a pretty big 12-year-old all of 5'8" kick a soccer ball, hit me right in the solar plexus.
Yeah.
That doesn't feel good either.
Dr. Robert Martin's going over to check on this guy over there. He's up.
I can't imagine this big 350-plus pound body landing on a football. I'd be done for the day.
No.
Give a shout-out to my buddy Roger Laster, who's home listening to the Granger game. Came in many years, but he's home listening to it on the radio tonight.
Good deal. All right, Cavaliers back to the line of scrimmage. One receiver right, one receiver left, and Ramsey's going to keep it himself. Across the 40 to the 45-yard line. Had me fooled. I thought he had handed the ball off, and apparently a couple other Grangers thought so too, because they were trying to tackle Gabriel Moultrie, and Ramsey pulled the ball out of the belly of Moultrie and took it himself and got the first down.
Yeah, option going to the right side. If you on this triple option, if you can make the quarterback pitch it, you're doing a good job. That time he didn't have to pitch, and he got a lot of yardage.
One receiver either side, this time a straight handoff, and Atkins is bouncing around and not getting anywhere. He tried one way, ran into a Granger, tried the other way, ran into somebody, and finally he got, he didn't get any yardage out of that. Second down and 10.
I think the whole Granger sideline was on that side of the ball, stopping that running back.
We've had good pursuit on defense all night tonight as far as on the run defense.
Second and 10. Rangers trailing 17-0. 10:45 to go in the third quarter. One receiver right, one left, and all kinds of movement on the Grangers.
I think we jumped
into the neutral zone. Nobody moved that I saw on the Callaway side, and yep, the far judge is looking to step it off the other way.
He probably changed up that cadence a little bit.
Yeah, that's a design play, the hard count play where, he'll hard count on his usual snap signal.
I'm going to talk about this in just a minute. The Cavaliers done this a few times, but right now Ramsey under center with two receivers left. Backs in the I formation.
And we've got an ineligible receiver. That inside receiver is on the line of scrimmage.
I thought so, too.
But
I'm glad you're here for that. Now, the handoff up the middle to about the 49-yard line. No flag on that. Now, explain that rule before we go to the other one.
Okay, if you're to be an eligible receiver, you have to be the uncovered man on the line of scrimmage. You cannot be up on the line of scrimmage with somebody outside on this line of scrimmage also. Therefore, if the ball was thrown and that inside receiver had gone down the field, it would be an ineligible man downfield.
Okay. But if they had a tight end there, you could have a receiver on the line of scrimmage, right?
No. No, not with a tight end. No. That tight end would be ineligible if the wide receiver is on the line of scrimmage along with the tight end.
The flag.
They move this time.
Yep. Now, going back to what I was going to get to before, there's been a few times where the Cavaliers are lining up in single file. The center is the center
at the front of the line.
Is at the ball, and then all the rest of the team is in single file. And then once they get set, then they separate, kind of giving just a few seconds less, I guess, for the Grangers to get set up as to where they're going
to
be.
Yeah, they're trying to catch the Grangers off guard, trying to make adjustments to the quick lineup.
Third down and 8.
But we've been able to play that. See how this – now the two receivers now are off the line. They're both eligible.
But they're going to pitch the ball at the last second. Ramsey – just gets hit as he pitches the ball to the trailing back, who get up to the 50-yard line. But now it's fourth down.
Good job by the Granger defense forcing the pitch and running and cornering up the running back before he gets to the first down marker.
Let's watch for fate.
Always have to be careful of that.
Punter standing just inside his 40. We owe you a station ID. We'll get it to you as quick as we can. There's the kick. It is up. It is fair caught at the 20-yard line. First and 10 Grangers. Back in 10 seconds for station identification here on the Eagle Sports Radio Network.
You're listening to LaGrange Grangers Football on WCJM FM West Point 100.9 The Bull. Tonight's game is brought to you in part by RE/MAX Results Agents Rob and Joel Upchurch.
LaGrange nothing with 8:29 left to go in the third quarter. LaGrange with the ball first and 10 on their own 19-yard line. Michael Buchanan alongside Cal Hires. Tommy Whitworth on the sideline. There's the handoff up the middle to about the 20-yard line for a gain of 1. That's Cornell Kendrick on the carry. Our producer is Tucker Browning. Our board operator is Taylor Sears.
That little handoff, I saw Cornell trying to break it outside the tackle. He had a little bit of a hole to run, but the Cavalier linebackers, quickly pursue and make a no gain out of it. But the offensive line seems to be opening up some creases in there for him.
It does. The Callaway just closes quick.
Yes,
very, very quick.
There's Kendrick again. He found that seam this time to the 30. 35, still on his feet, finally spilled at the 41-yard line. A 21-yard gain by Cornell Kendrick.
Right up the middle. Right up the middle. Just as pretty as you please. Cornell, not stopping and trying to juke. And I know he took a shot on his left leg from a defender that came over and made the tackle. He dove at his legs. And I think he's got what they call one of those Charlie horses.
First and 10, the Grangers down by 17, but driving. This time, trying to hand it a fake the jet sweep to the right, hand it off straight at the middle, but actually they're going to give him, looks like, maybe about a yard gain on the carry. Had that creased before, but not this time.
Yeah, the Cavalier defense was ready for it.
Quintavious Swanson and DJ Burks, number 80 in there. Did I see that right?
Is that him at the top of the split?
No, that's number 30. My mistake. Okay. That's 30. Dylan Norville.
there's the
late hit on. There's a late hit on quarterback. That's coming back.
50, 40, 30, 20, 10 in the end zone, but
they hit our quarterback on the head. Late hit. He's coming back.
Flag is on the field. Let's see what happens.
First down our way. All for naught for Callaway.
Interception by number 4, Kobe Jackson. Great effort on his part for what was apparent pick six, but the laundry on the field says nope.
Yeah, they had good pressure on Charles. I didn't see the hit. Was it pretty blatant there?
It was enough that you had to call that. I mean, you really did. He hit him a little late and hit him a little high. And he didn't really make an effort to pull back.
There you go.
Just a little anxious on you know, not a malicious.
No, but thing, I think they'd also call that the college level, too.
Yes. Let's see how this.
Big break for LaGrange. We need to take advantage of this one.
Fresh set of downs for the Grangers. First and 10 from the Cavalier 47. One receiver to the right side, backs in the wing tee. There's a pitch to Norvell, and he gets hit helmet to helmet. Dropped at the 45-yard line. Gain of 2.
He might be a little woozy on that one.
Yeah, he got hit twice. He hit him on the helmet, and then he hit the ground.
So he'll come out, and looks like Miles Johnson is going in. Miles Johnson's going in, and, Swanson is staying out there as well. He split out to the right side. Crawford, double reverse, ball's on the ground, and it's going to be recovered by Callaway.
Just a bad exchange there.
Yeah. Had the handoff one way, and on the double reverse, handoff the other way, and never got a handle on it.
Just missed the pocket, and Callaway takes advantage of the situation. Then this is part of the game where the Grangers have to bear down and get the ball back. You can't give up now.
Well, if it got that second handoff, I believe he would have had
a lot of real estate to deal with.
Yep. Cavaliers at the Granger 48, leading by 17. Two receivers right. Ramsey with the handoff, and he's got room to the 40, first down, 35. And number 14, Cartavius Bigsby, gets a big run for the first down.
A great crackback block there, Michael, from the Callaway wide receiver. He came back and got pads on our outside linebacker, which sprang that play.
15-yard run. Callaway leading 17-0. Two receivers right, and Ramsey's going to keep it himself. A nice tackle. Guys rode him down to the ground. Who is that? Number 10 for the Grangers,
Jacoby Smith.
And kept his helmet and got a good tackle on that, or else Ramsey may still be running.
Yeah, he rode the fullback into the line of scrimmage. He kept that ball in that fullback's gut for a long time before he finally pulled it. Too bad they didn't fumble it.
Second and 5. Ramsey. Oh, quick handoff up the middle is going to have the first down. Just a quick as a hiccup explosion up the middle.
Yeah, the quarterback opens up to the left, hands off, and turns and spins and runs the option with the running back going the other way, going out to the right. And it's just a real hard play for the linebackers to
It's like a back seam dive.
Yes, sir, it is.
One receiver split out way off to the right side, one to the left. Ramsey under center, backs in the eye. There's the pitch to Bigsby. And he got slowed up by one tackler and is brought down by another back at the 30-yard line.
Got some laundry on the field, too. I don't know what that's about.
I was fixing to say the cornerback for LaGrange came in to make a great play, and the Callaway wide receiver was just pushing him all in the back before.
Yeah, you got it. Back, blocking the back.
Robert Thornton on the tackle.
Who's the corner over there on the far side? I can't see the number.
I think it's Vondez Taylor. No, it wasn't him.
17?
LaQuincy. Yeah. That's right. Yeah, LaQuincy made a great play pursuing the sweep with the wide receiver just pushing him all in the back.
With the penalty, that'll push it way back. First down from the
first and 23.
36. They need the 13. So there's the handoff across the 35 to the 30, 25, and number 15, Quay Hines, is spilled around the 24-yard line. Got a lot of that real estate back.
Got 12 yards of it back.
Yeah, got some good blocking on his offensive left side. And there was a couple of Grangers that had a shot at him, but he just outran, flat out ran them.
Second and 11. 3:40 left to go in the third quarter. Callaway leading 17-0. Gosh, the Grangers had their chances. We've seen that a lot last year. Two receivers right, one left. And Ramsey, under a lot of pressure, trying to escape, trying to find room, and he may get room. 20, 15, 10, and down to the 7-yard line. He had two Grangers just bottling him up, and he just escaped them. Is his name Ramsey or Houdini?
he is a cool cat under pressure.
It took a special athlete to outrun that pressure just then, because we had him. We had him dead to right.
That's an athlete.
Yes, he is.
First and goal from the Granger 8. Two receivers right. Backs in the I formation. Ramsey under center. Gonna hand the ball off to Atkins, trying to find his way. He does find the crease. He has stood up, though, at the 5-yard line, and that is it. He was patient. The hole closed up on him real quick, and they just waited, and then he found the crease and then got a few yards on it before he was stood up.
Yeah, that's right, Michael. He stopped at the line of scrimmage, and all of a sudden the momentum of the offensive line went one way, and he stepped back to the left, and like you said, he found that little crease and got a few yards out of it. That's really impressive, being able to pick out his hole like that.
Second and goal from the 5. One receiver right, one left. Ramsey under center. Bigsby dotting the I. And
illegal formation. He had about 9 people up on the line.
What was the formation there, though?
All of them line up on the line. Eight of them on there.
Hey, you can have them up on the line of scrimmage. You just can't have more than 4 of them in the backfield.
LaGrange takes a timeout. We'll take a 30-second timeout with them. 17-0 Cavaliers. Back in 30 seconds, this is LaGrange High, Granger Football on the Eagles Sports Network.
LaGrange Banking is growing. We've opened a new location in Columbus, and we've adopted a new name that reflects our community roots with an eye on future. Welcome to Calumet Bank, offering personal and business banking services with the friendliness of neighbors. We work on your schedule, offering daytime business hours and a complete set of mobile apps. Day or night, we've got you covered. Calumet Bank, same great services from people you already know. Life is better at Calumet. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Ramsey trying that right side on the keeper. Gets across the five, down to the four, and brought down there. Third down.
We were both wrong on that delay of gain.
Oh, delay of gain.
I asked
a side judge over here, and she told me it was a delay of gain.
Well, you know, we do have these clocks here that are functioning. You think that we, the broadcasters, would look at them. We didn't do that. Obviously, the quarterback didn't do that. Third down and goal from the four. Ramsey. He's going to take it himself, and he's just going to step into the end zone for the touchdown. Handed it off, faked the handoff up the middle, and a couple of Grangers bit on that, and he was just able to bootleg it out to the left side for the touchdown.
Great fake. Had me faked out because I knew for sure we'd stop that running back short of the goal line, and then all of a sudden there's the quarterback running into the end zone.
Extra point attempt is coming up. Snap, spot, kick. It is up, and it is good. Time out of the field with 55 seconds left to go in the third quarter. It's now Callaway 24 and LaGrange nothing. We'll be back after this one-minute break. This is the Grange High Granger football on the Eagle Sports Network.
When it comes to your health, nobody beats the home team at WellStar West Georgia Medical Center. Named number one large hospital by Georgia Trend magazine. Nationally ranked the top 100 hospital by Truven Health. And one of the 100 great community hospitals by Becker's Hospital Review. WellStar West Georgia Medical Center is your award-winning team in LaGrange. Visit wellstar.org/WGMC to learn more. We believe in life well lived.
Tara, are you okay?
Yes, I can't believe you found me. I have car trouble and there you are.
Yeah, that's State Farm's 24/7 access.
It's like we have this mental telepathy, you know?
Well, you did start filing your claim with your mobile device. You can access State Farm on your phone, online, even in person at one of the 18,000 neighborhood
State Farm offices. See? Mental telepathy.
State Farm is there for you anytime, anywhere. Get to a better state. State Farm.
Connect telepathically with Agent Matt Orr on the square in downtown LaGrange.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Back again here at Callaway Stadium, a 48-yard drive culminating in a 3-yard touchdown run by Ramsey. Makes it 24-0 Callaway. And on the ensuing kickoff, it was... Was that Dylan Norville?
Dylan Norville.
On the return.
It was impressive.
Yeah, a whole lot of east to west running, some north to south. He did field it inside the five, got out to the 21-yard line.
He ran 50 yards.
He ran 50 yards to get three, didn't he, Tommy?
He certainly did. He earned every inch of it.
So now the Grangers, first and 10 from the 21. And all a right. Quick pass to Cornell Kendrick. They're going to say hit before he was thrown. Here comes the flag.
We may have got a holding on the other side and a hit on this side. We got two flags down.
But going back to that long run to get 3 yards, Tommy, you know that's how... Kenny Stabler got his nickname, the Snake.
That is correct.
He ran about 104 yards to make a 3-yard touchdown.
Holding against the Grange. And the White Hat says, hold on. No. They're not going to call the pass interference.
Move the ball back to the 10-yard line.
I thought there were two penalties
there
on
was.
This.
Yeah, the referee back here in the back threw a flag
toward the receiver. It looked like there was some pass interference or contact before, but I guess the other penalty had already happened. I guess it took precedent over.
I don't know. Two receivers right, one left, first and 21. And they're just going to hand the ball off up the middle and get to about the 10-yard line, second down.
Yeah, on an obvious passing play, you want to. We tried to run that draw, but that had worked before. But the Cavalier defensive line right there on it. We're going to the fourth quarter, it looks like.
Yeah, I think they're just going to let the clock run with 6 seconds, 5 seconds, 4 seconds. Yep, that's going to be the end of the third quarter of play. Got to go get them. Grangers down 24-0 as we head to the fourth quarter of play. We'll be back after this one-minute break. This is LaGrange High Granger football on the Eagles Sports Network.
It's a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at REMAX Results because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
Here's Perry Prather, head pharmacist at Holmes Pharmacy.
The joy of coming into work in the pharmacy every day is to interact with the patients, get a feel for them, understand them, love them, first of all. You got to love your patients. You got to love people. That's what we do. As a person and as a business, that's my thing, is I want to give them the exceptional care. Everybody that comes in here that we care about and they feel like this is home for them when they get the medicine.
HolmesPharmacy.com in LaGrange and Hamilton.
Now back to LaGrange Granger football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Second and 21 for the Grangers, back on their own 10-yard line. And unfortunately, Charles Crawford is going to be hemmed up back around the 5 and brought down. They'll give him forward progress to the 6.
That Cavalier defensive line just overpowering now, pinning their ears back, knowing that we got to throw the ball, and it's really tough to protect him whenever you got meat eaters on the line like that.
Third down and 25 by my math.
Third 23.
Swanson split out to the left, to the right side. Crawford under center. Back to the wing tee. They're going to hand the ball off, and he's not going to get anywhere. He'll get a couple yards to the 9. I thought Kendrick had the ball at first. He acted like he had the ball, but that wasn't wanted to be in the case.
Yeah, that was an attempt at the button sweep, I believe, and just didn't quite get the blocking out on the corner. I mean, well, the sweep, the regular sweep. We didn't get the block on the corner that we needed.
Callaway number 2, E.K. Wilkerson.
It was like Coach Burke said, we're one player, one block away from breaking it big.
There's the punt.
Blocked back in the end zone, 2 points.
Safety.
They have been getting penetration through our offensive line on all the special. I mean, they're double loading and coming straight up the middle. Same thing they did on the block field goal.
26.
That makes it 26. Nothing Cavaliers. Back in 30 seconds. This is LaGrange High Granger football on the Eagles Sports Network.
There's a secret to beating injuries or ailments. Get the right team. Emory Southern Orthopedics, well-trained, experienced doctors, nurses, and staff are that team. These teammates listen and understand your specific condition and provide high-quality hometown care that will get you back into your game. For more information about Emory Southern Orthopedics team, visit www.southernorthopedics.com.
Now back to LaGrange Wager football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Well, the Grangers started at the 21-yard line and wound up with a blocked punt for a safety. And I thought that was just good penetration. It wasn't a slow snap. It wasn't a bobble. It wasn't a high snap. It wasn't, you know, anything Greeny did wrong.
It was a levee break.
It was the blocking. I will say that. It was lack of blocking.
There were more Cavaliers in the backfield than
the 20-yard number 16.
And there were Grangers.
So the Grangers will kick from the 20-yard line after the safety. And the kick is going to be fielded at the 20-yard line. 25-30. Hurdles the tackler, 35, and then spilled at the 39-yard line.
Bartavius Bigsby for Callaway. Tackled near the 38-yard line. Injury timeout on the field.
There's some hitting going on down there, Michael, Tommy.
Absolutely, and you know, that was a good long kick. He'd be kicking off from the 20. And
Chris Watson of the Grange. Injury timeout on the field.
With the injury timeout, we'll take a 30-second timeout with it. 26-0 Cavaliers, 10:14 to go in the game. Back in 30 seconds, this is LaGrange High, Granger Football on the Eagle Sports Network.
LaGrange Banking is growing. We've opened a new location in Columbus, and we've adopted a new name that reflects our community roots with an eye on the future. Welcome to Calumet Bank, offering personal and business banking services with the friendliness of neighbors. We work on your schedule, offering daytime business hours and a complete set of mobile apps. Day or night, we've got you covered. Calumet Bank, same great services from people you already know. Life is better at Calumet. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Back again here at Callaway Stadium. 26-0 Cavaliers with the lead. And the young man now off the field. And I'm sorry, I was communicating with our producer, Tucker Browning here. Was he able to get off on his own? And
I didn't notice either. I was looking at the roster.
Okay, good.
First
and 10 for the Cavaliers. Ramsey's in the shotgun. He's going to hand it off to Atkins. He's going to take the sweep to the left side and get brought down around the 42-yard line.
Granger defense got to show some backbone now to, you know, stop the leaking.
For the Grange, pick him up 3 yards, second at 7. Ball's at the 42-yard line.
Cavaliers just going to be happy to let the clock run down probably as much as possible. Milking some clock. Two receivers to the right side, one left. And a flag thrown. And they're going to say false start.
Here's a little 13 on him. Number for Callaway. Let's see, his name is
false start charge you, Callaway. That's a
13 for Callaway.
Antonez Blunt. Yep. And LaQuincy Shepherd kind of were going back and forth at it.
Bobby plays back to the
one too many moves.
Well, he's second and 12.
Back it up 5 yards. Brings up second down and around 12.
He did it again.
And,
yep.
Yeah, he's not getting set soon enough before the ball snapped. And the poor kid doesn't understand it.
I got some clarification on that. What we thought would have been an interference down here in the flat over here. The ball never crossed the line of scrimmage when he threw the ball. And so it negated the interference.
Okay.
Good point.
So two receivers right. There's the pitch. And Atkins is brought down around the 36-yard line.
Kick back the 36-yard line by the Grange.
Bring the third down and about 13 by my math.
Dexter Patrick with a tackle for the Grange. pick up a 4 yard little point. See, third down at 13. Ball's at the 36 yard line.
Trying to find some Region 5 Quad A scores for you, but unfortunately, the Score Atlanta app is broken, I think. It's stuck loading this. Whole lot of folks getting scores here on opening night. Ramsey, under pressure, fires and is hit immediately and brought down at the 30-yard line.
That's a great play. That's a Dexter Fitzpatrick. He saw the running back flaring out for the reception, and he just made a beeline straight to him and knocked him out.
Jaquez Smith put good pressure on the quarterback, too.
Dexter Fitzpatrick wearing that number 2 proudly. Doing it right. There's the punt.
Bad punt.
Yep. And it takes a big Granger bounce like a Todd Willis chip shot back to the 42-yard line.
Yeah, that ball had some spin on it, and it spun back.
A lob wedge, man, I tell you. Yeah.
Wow. All the way back to the 42 inside Cavalier territory. Granger's hand the ball off, trying to get that right side. And Andre Canty, the running back, getting a couple of, about a yard loss on that carry.
He needed to wait for his offensive lineman to make the block for him. He ran right by his offensive lineman into the defender that he was that his blocker was about to block. That's what I liked about Justin Patterson. He could always run off his line and his blocks.
Second and 12. And there's number 20 once again. Canty trying that right side. He'll get that yard back.
That was a little inside reverse again.
He's a spark. He's a little spark plug in a way. He runs with a very low center of gravity and is very shifty and quick. He's going to be fun to watch grow up.
Yes, he is.
Third and 10. One receiver left, two on the right side. Back to pass and thrown and caught. Did he guess?
He did.
Caught it at the 31, diving for it. And he's got the first down.
Quantavius Swanson got it.
That was a good throw, great catch, and excellent protection.
Looked that ball in as he was diving. Good focus. Clock running, 6:26 left to go in the game. Callaway leading 26-0. LaGrange driving, one receiver to the left side. One to the right. Crawford looking under pressure, tucks it and drops.
Back sack near the 38-yard line.
The pocket just broke down on him.
Yeah, the Cavalier defenders were all over our receivers. All four of them were covered.
Yeah, that's going to get distracting. Folks with their phones out on the Cavalier side. Look at the student section, some others with that light shining.
I think we're doing it on our side too. So
are we?
Yeah.
I can't. God love the student sections battling each other. That's fun. Two receivers right, one left. Third and 10.
Good catch.
Yeah. Nice catch. Number 11, that is Jordan Ogletree.
Ogletree cut on it good. It was a great curl.
I guess I can get used to that because 11 was Ahmad Ogletree.
Yeah. A good slant route that he ran, and the ball's thrown just a little bit behind him where he had to slide to catch it, but a great reception nonetheless.
Now it's third down 10. Excuse me, third down and six, looks like. One receiver right, one left. Crawford's under pressure. Down he goes. That offensive line is just having a hard time blocking these Cavaliers.
Yeah, the defensive line is just so persistent. And, you know, they got the backups in. They got their ears pinned back because they know that we're going to drop back and throw. But, you know, we got a tired offensive line out there right now.
Third and 11.
Got another flag coming. He walking up there real slow like he's thinking about what he's going to call. I don't know what he...
I'm not sure. Waiting for the white hat to...
I'm sitting here. LePerion, tell us about fall camp.
I mean, it's been going good.
Is it a little bit faster here? Can you keep up with them?
Oh, yeah, it's a little faster. A lot of things you got to learn in a couple of days.
Different level of ball, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
School going good for you?
Yes, sir, it is.
When's y'all's first ball game?
August 31st, Fort Valley.
Fort Valley, is it going to be here?
Here.
All right, August 31st, Fort Valley versus West Georgia.
LaGrange takes a timeout. We'll take a 1 minute timeout with them. 4:03 to go in the game. Rangers trailing 26-0. Back in a minute. This is LaGrange High, Granger football on the Eagles Sports Network.
When it comes to your health, nobody beats the home team at WellStar West Georgia Medical Center. Named number one large hospital by Georgia Trend Magazine. Nationally ranked a top 100 hospital by Truven Health. And one of the 100 great community hospitals by Becker's Hospital Review. WellStar West Georgia Medical Center is your award-winning team in LaGrange. Visit wellstar.org/WGMC to learn more. We believe in life well lived.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at RE/MAX Results because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
Now back to LaGrange Granger football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Crawford takes a snap, back to pass, and just overthrows the intended receiver. Now the ball goes over on downs.
Oh, if he could have got that ball down, Michael, he had a lot of green in front of him to run.
.359 left to go in the game. Cavaliers with the lead, 26-0. One receiver either side. And the running back, number 7, Travis Traylor, a senior, getting a couple yards out of it. That's it.
Tackled by Vondez Taylor. He's playing the outside Travis linebacker.
Number 21 on the stop.
No, he's the corner. Outside linebacker, yeah.
Pick up a few yards, second and 8.
One receiver left, one right. Backs in the I formation. Ramsey under center. Going to give it to the running back who is dotting that I. And
oh, inadvertent whistle.
Yeah.
yeah. Who's that, number 27?
We got a hurt player,
Charlie
too.
Dixon. Charlie Dixon caught the ball, would not go down, and don't know, for some reason the referees blew the whistle while he was still running.
Well, I'm thinking they thought that his progress had stopped, because in all fairness, it really had, but he was still churning his legs. He was still trying, but now the player for the Cavaliers is down. And I'm thinking this might be a cramp the way they're pushing on that leg. At least we hope so anyway. We'll take a 30-second timeout here. 3:10 to go in the game. 26-0 Cavaliers. Back in 30 seconds on the LaGrange High Eagles Nest Sports Network.
Here's Perry Prather, head pharmacist at Holmes Pharmacy.
The joy of coming into work in the pharmacy every day is to interact with the patients, get a feel for them, understand them, love them. First of all, you got to love your patients. You got to love people. That's what we do. And as a person and as a business, that's my thing, is I want to give them the exceptional care. Everybody that comes in here that we care about and they feel like this is home for them.
HomesPharmacy.com in LaGrange and Hamilton.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Couldn't tell the number of the player for the Cavaliers, but he was able to get off on his own power. Definitely a good thing.
Keyshawn Cameron, number 52.
Thank you. Those silver numbers on white jerseys is driving me crazy. I was talking with Shane, the play-by-play guy for the Cavaliers, said it drove him crazy last year, too.
It's not much better down here on the field, but you are a little closer.
And a timeout called by Callaway. We'll take a 30-second timeout with him. Still 26-0 Cavaliers. Back after this break on the Eagle Sports Radio Network.
Tara, are you okay?
Yes, I can't believe you found me. I have car trouble and there you are.
Yeah, that's State Farm's 24/7 access.
It's like we had this mental telepathy, you know?
Well, you did start filing your claim with your mobile device. You can access State Farm on your phone, online, even in person at one of the 18,000 neighborhood
State Farm offices. See? Mental telepathy.
State Farm is there for you anytime, anywhere. Get to a better state. State Farm.
Connect telepathically with Agent Matt Orr on the square in downtown LaGrange.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
2:46 left to go in the game. Callaway leading 26-0. Cavaliers with 3rd and 7 at the 30-yard line. Two receivers right, one left. Ramsey under center, backs in the I formation. Fakes the handoff, Ramsey looking, rolling out, throwing it long, throwing it deep, throwing it over everybody. Number 32, it looks like, for Callaway's, Sidarian Sheely, was at the 35, but the ball was at the 30. That'll bring up fourth down.
A good job by the Grangers secondary staying with those pass patterns, because they did one little cross and luckily we weren't fooled with it.
High snap over the head of the punter at the 5, at the 3. He's going to try to run at the 5. He's knocked out of bounds at the inside the 10-yard line, so the Grangers get the ball first.
They got a hold on them, too. Ball went out on 13. They threw a penalty flag on about the 2. Looked like one of the Cavaliers was holding. Let's see how this will work out.
Well, if he's holding at the 2, that's half the distance to the goal. It's first and goal for the Grangers at the 1.
I'm going to put the goal on the 1-yard line.
White Hat's talking the options over to Charles Crawford. Let's see, holding against Callaway, declining it.
Yeah, that would Callaway would retain possession.
Oh, yeah. Good point. Yeah, we don't want to give him an extra down, especially when that was fourth down.
Really?
Yeah, if it had been holding in the end zone, though, it would have been a safety.
Yes, it would have.
And that was very close to holding in the end zone.
Yeah, he was. They were just on the outside the end zone when the hold occurred.
So 2:29 left to go in the game. LaGrange with the ball, first and 10 at the Cavalier 9-yard line. And they're going to hand the ball off to number 32 for LaGrange. That is Andreka Martin.
Really an early whistle on that.
That was an early whistle because he was still spinning and fighting for yardage.
Yeah.
What an injustice.
Well, the line of scrimmage, Michael, it was a 14 to start
you're
with.
Correct.
He gained 5 yards on that. So.
So now it's the 9. I was wondering why that other stick was up there around the 4. So we're sitting here looking down the 45-yard line and far off down there. So second down and 5. And there's the pitch to number 20. He's hung up this side of the 10-yard line, dropped around the 11-yard line. And that's Andre Canty with the carry.
And we tried to run the sweep out there. He got by the initial surge of pursuit, but Callaway's linebackers and secondary did a great job of coming up and stopping the play.
Callaway has just got a lot of speed on that perimeter out there. They've contained it real well all night tonight.
Yeah.
Quantavia Swanson on the far side, Colby Patton on the near side. Crawford is looking to throw to one of them, but the whistles are blown, the flags are thrown.
Well, that was a good penalty. We had an illegal procedure over here to give us one more down.
Yeah, our wide receiver was checking with the referee to make sure he was lined up on the line. And while he was talking, he made his adjustment. He stepped, but the ball was snapped while he was making the step.
Ouch.
He was talking to her.
Her. Okay. I didn't want to make that bad mistake.
Back to pass. Crawford throws, tipped, and incomplete. Fourth down.
Jordan Ogletree had a good inside seam on that, though. It was just a little hot and a little high.
Yeah, he had plenty of room to run with if he comes down with the ball.
So fourth down.
And
the Grangers need the 4-yard line, just inside the 4-yard line for the first.
DJ Burks is now in, Michael. He's going to be split out wide to the left here.
He caught a touchdown pass in the Heard County scrimmage in the second half. They're going to throw it an incomplete in and out of the hands of Ogletree. Ball goes over on downs.
A slant play that Ogletree ran was a good route, and the ball was right there. It was just a matter of catching it and holding on to it. But the secondary, I think, would have stopped him short of the end zone because they were defending it really well.
We have a great special at the concession stand at this time. Hot dogs are on sale.
We'll have the second half recap coming up in the post-game show. We'll have a post-game interview with Coach Burks. Let's get as many scores as we can as Cavaliers take a knee.
It's good to talk to LaPierre and Perry on the sideline. He's
definitely
really
was
excited about going to college and playing up there in Carrollton with the West Georgia team. And they're going to put him as slot receiver, he said.
Now that's exciting. That's a good position for him.
That's going to be the end of the game as both teams are just now leaving the field. Your final score, Callaway Cavaliers 26 and LaGrange nothing. We'll take a quick 1-minute break. as the coaches and players get together, and then we'll come back with the coaches' interview. This is the Grange High, Granger Football, the Eagles Sports Network.
Injuries or ailments, get the right team. Emory Southern Orthopedics, well-trained, experienced doctors, nurses, and staff are that team. These teammates listen and understand your specific condition and provide high-quality hometown care that will get you back into your game. For more information about Emory Southern Orthopedics team, visit www.southernorthopedics.com.
LaGrange Banking is growing. We've opened a new location in Columbus, and we've adopted a new name that reflects our community roots with an eye on the future. Welcome to Calumet Bank, offering personal and business banking services with the friendliness of neighbors. We work on your schedule, offering daytime business hours and a complete set of mobile apps. Day or night, we've got you covered. Calumet Bank, same great services from people you already know. Life is better at Calumet. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
And we're back again here at Callaway Stadium as the Grangers fall to the Callaway Cavaliers 26-0. Still waiting for the Coach Burks to come.
Making his rounds with the Callaway coaches over there.
And I tell you what, those Callaway coaches are good folks. I've worked with Coach Wiggins and Coach Hubbard back in 2007, I believe it was, when I was doing both LaGrange and Callaway on a different radio station. And the staying with it for all these years, they've really built a really good program there.
Yes, they have. I mean, you know, a good facility, but the main thing is you get the boys out, the ones that are capable of playing, and, you know, you have a good workout program, you make it fun for them, and they'll come year after year and play for you. Just a real good, solid, fundamental program they got over there.
Got a good foundation there, and hopefully here at LaGrange, we'll keep building on the foundation here. Coach Burks does a great job with these kids, getting them ready for college, getting them ready for the next level, whether it be on the field or off the field. And hey, hopefully we'll have him here a long
Michael,
time.
Michael, you got me.
Go ahead.
Mike, got Coach Burks here.
Go ahead.
First game over with. Score knotted anywhere we want to, but I have to give them an A for heart.
Well, when you look at it, we're going to go back and watch the film. Of course, it's not what we want it to be, by far. But we have a lot of stuff we have to clean up. But the main thing I'm proud of right now, just looking at them, are the attitude. Are the attitude where they at. I don't see anybody dropping their heads. I see people still encouraging each other. So when you look at that, that's going to take you a long way.
It really will, Ed, and you could get that sense on the sideline over there, even though it wasn't bouncing our way. They believe. And you've got a good, tight coaching staff and a good, tight group of kids out there. They're just young, and we learn from them.
Well, our big three for the week was we had to play physical. You know, we wanted to play physical, pad level. One pad level, and then you want to believe, you know. Just like you said, and that's what I'm looking at with these guys. You know, we're fine, we're okay. You know, it's a lot that it's Callaway and it's crosstown rival, but you know, we take each week at a time. This game is over, so now we got to look forward to Villarica.
That's it, Coach. Be with your team. Have a good week of practice. We'll be back next week.
Yes, sir. We're gonna have a great week of practice. We'll be back.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Thank you, Tommy. 26-0, your final score. The Cavaliers with the win. We'll tell you how the second half went when we come back after this 3-minute break. This is LaGrange High, Granger Football on the Eagle Sports Network.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at Remax Results because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
Tara, are you okay?
Yes, I can't believe you found me. I have car trouble and there you are.
Yeah, that's State Farm's 24/7 access.
It's like we have this mental telepathy, you know?
Well, you did start filing your claim with your mobile device. You can access State Farm on your phone, online, even in person at one of the 18,000 neighborhoods.
State Farm offices, see? Mental telepathy.
State Farm is there for you anytime, anywhere. Get to a better state. State Farm.
Connect telepathically with Agent Matt Orr on the square in downtown LaGrange.
Here's Perry Prather, head pharmacist at Holmes Pharmacy.
The joy of coming into work in the pharmacy every day is to interact with the patients, get a feel for them, understand them, love them. First of all, you got to love your patients. You got to love people. That's what we do. And as a person and as a business, that's my thing, is I want to give them the exceptional care. Everybody is going to come in here that we care about them and that they feel like this is home to them when they get the medicine.
HolmesPharmacy.com in LaGrange and Hamilton.
When it comes to your health, nobody beats the home team at WellStar West Georgia Medical Center. Named number one large hospital by Georgia Trend magazine. Nationally ranked a top 100 hospital by Truven Health. And one of the 100 great community hospitals by Becker's Hospital Review. WellStar West Georgia Medical Center is your award-winning team in LaGrange. Visit wellstar.org/WGMC to learn more. We believe in life well lived.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at Remax Results because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
LaGrange Banking is growing. We've opened a new location in Columbus, and we've adopted a new name that reflects our community roots with an eye on the future. Welcome to Calumet Bank, offering personal and business banking services with the friendliness of neighbors. We work on your schedule, offering daytime business hours and a complete set of mobile apps. Day or night, we've got you covered. Calumet Bank, same great services from people you already know. Life is better at Calumet. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Now back to LaGrange Granger Football on 100.9 WCJM, The Bull.
Back again here at Callaway Stadium. The Grangers fall to the Callaway Cavaliers 26-0. It was 17-0 at the half, and then the Grange did what they needed to do. Callaway make the Cavaliers punt on the first drive, and then the Grange started their own 19-yard line, got into Callaway territory to the 45, and then fumbled the ball away. Callaway starting at the Granger 48-yard line. And they went the full 48 yards. A 3-yard touchdown run by Ramsey extended the lead to 24-0. Then LaGrange got the ball at their own 21-yard line and went backwards. Fourth down, they went to punt. A blocked punt through the back of the end zone for a safety. And that made the score 26-0. And then they couldn't get anything going. The two teams exchanged punts on three and outs. Callaway went to punt after the three and out, had a bad snap that LaGrange got at the Callaway 14-yard line, but couldn't even scrap a first down out of that. Wound up turning the ball over on downs, and then Callaway ran the clock out. Young team, and my wife makes fun of me when I say the Grangers are young. She says, yeah, they're young. They're a bunch of teenagers. Well, they're all teenagers. Well, we mentioned the name of sophomore after sophomore after sophomore after sophomore who's got talent, but they're going to need some seasoning. They're going to need some snaps. They're going to need some real-time reps, and they got a lot of that today.
Yeah, and, you know, it was a good experience for those kids that, you know, like you said, that are young, battlefield experience, I guess we should say, is what they need. And, you know, as a sophomore, you're coming in, and you're learning a lot. But this is where your experience and your physical maturity come together to make yourself that type of player that will make a difference.
And make no mistake about it, Kendrick Ramsey's a good quarterback. We're going to see him play on Saturdays next year. DJ Atkins, DQ Wilkerson, and on and on and on we go. Quay Hines, Cartavius Bigsby, they made some plays.
Yes, they did.
They're good athletes. Take nothing away from Callaway. It's not just because there's a lot of youth on the Granger team. They're good players, and yes, they're going to play well the rest of the season.
And they showed LaGrange that they were the faster and stronger team on the field. But you know, I expect Callaway to make it pretty deep in the playoffs.
Yeah.
And you know, there'll be people looking at the Grangers after this game saying, "Oh, they don't have a chance to make postseason." Well, this is where you get back the following week. You correct your mistakes and you get better week after week. And you know, you just never can tell what can happen toward the end of the season.
The 2001, I did the radio for Auburn High School. I've told the story before. That was a young team who graduated a lot of kids. Unfortunately, their head coach passed away during the off season. So Dwight Jones, who started the program at Northside, also coached at Harris County, he came over to coach that 1 year for Auburn High School. He took a lot of young kids who had no business making the playoffs, had to hope that that Enterprise beat Smith Station the last week of the season, so that Auburn and Smith Station had the same record. Auburn had beaten Smith Station, so they had the head-to-head, mm-hmm, backdoor it in as a fourth seed, and made the semifinals.
Wow!
So that was a fun season.
Yes,
I'm not saying it could happen, but it's happened before with a young, talented bunch like LaGrange has. You know, you never know about high school football. You never know how far they'll progress.
That's for sure, Michael. You know, it, like I said, the level of maturity increases whenever you go through tough times like this. You can either let it make you stronger, or you know, you can let it whip you. And it's way too early in the season to let it be whipping you right now. But
yeah,
you know, this team's got a good future ahead of us, and you know, we'll get better and we'll correct our mistakes, and you know, this team could be the surprise of the region.
When we come back, we'll have some scores from around Region 5. When we come back after this 3-minute break, 26-0 Callaway over LaGrange. Back in 3 minutes. This is LaGrange High Granger football on the Eagle Sports Network.
Deciding to sell or buy a home is a big step. To make sure it's a step in the right direction, choose the person best qualified to handle your real estate needs. Joel and Rob Upchurch have been breaking sales records every year since 1997. They truly are the real estate leaders in West Georgia. So take a step in the right direction. Contact Joel or Rob Upchurch at RE/MAX Results, because they are dedicated to results and converting transactions into relationships.
There's a secret to beating injuries or ailments. Get the right team. Emory Southern Orthopedics, well-trained, experienced doctors, nurses, and staff are that team. These teammates listen and understand your specific condition and provide high-quality hometown care that will get you back into your game. For more information about Emory Southern Orthopedics team, visit www.southernorthopedics.com.
Here's Perry Prather, head pharmacist at Holmes Pharmacy.
The joy of coming into work in the pharmacy every day is to interact with the patients, get a feel for them, understand them. Love them, first of all. You got to love your patients. You got to love people. That's what we do. And as a person and as a business, that's my thing, is I want to give them the exceptional care. Everybody is going to come to here that we care about and that they feel like this is home for them when they get the medicine.
HolmesPharmacy.com in LaGrange and Hamilton.
When it comes to your health, nobody beats the home team at WellStar West Georgia Medical Center. Named number one large hospital by Georgia Trend Magazine.
nationally ranked a top 100 hospital by Truven Health.